Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to the Watertown Municipal Arena on this Sunday evening matchup between your Watertown Wolves and the Binghamton Black Bears. Third game of the weekend. Binghamton took the win on home ice 5-2 on Friday night. Watertown a 4-2 win last night here in the Watertown Municipal Arena, and trying to gather three more points here tonight against the division clinching Binghamton Black Bears. Hello, everybody. My name is Jeff Barrett. Joining me up here on the deck on the color commentary and on cameras, that is Connor Lalonde. Steve Weed is over in the next booth at the controls. Well, it's pretty simple. Coming down towards the end of the season, as I said, Watertown 3 points behind the Elmira River Sharks. Elmira, tough weekend out in Port Huron. Two shootout losses, on that trip out to the Midwest. Watertown gaining a little bit of ground with that win last night. Still has a ton of work to do as the end of the season starts to close out. We'll take a quick look at the standings in the Empire Division. You can see Binghamton 104 points already clinched. Motor City has a playoff position as well, just a couple of points ahead of Danbury, so that may flip-flop before the end of the year. And there it is, Elmira 54 points, Watertown 51 coming into tonight's action. So the work has to cut out for them, and that's what we're looking at here tonight, trying to grab three more points against the top team in the division. We're going to take a short break here. We're going to send you down to Brian Hunsinger, the house announcer here for the Watertown Wolves. He'll have the starting lineups and the introductions of our dignitaries here this evening.
and signing tonight's national anthem, Angelina Rolino.
Watertown Wolves. They've split the weekend so far, so the rubber match comes down to this Sunday evening here in Watertown. Quick look at our goaltenders here tonight. Nolan Egbert's going to get the start for the Binghamton Black Bears. 34 games played. He's 10-3-2 on the season with a 3.16 goals against average. And for the third night in a row, it'll be Spencer Kozlowski between the pipes for the Watertown Wolves with a 4.04 goals against, 5-14-2 on the year. So ceremonial puck drop down here before we get started with tonight's contest. Got to give a shout out to my buddy John Clement. John, I think for the first time missed a road trip in his illustrious career as an announcer. He celebrated 350 games last week broadcasting hockey. He was a little under the weather, didn't make the trip out west with the River Sharks, but did call the game from home. So a real trooper there. So hope you're feeling better, John. And I know you've already sent me a text and said you're listening, so you like to throw me off. I know I'll probably get a few texts throughout the evening. Also got to say hello to my friend Brooks Hill. Brooks, the voice of the Binghamton Black Bears in the building. He did a radio broadcast last night, did some podcast stuff. Not doing work tonight. He's sitting on the other side of the arena right now. Got a comfortable seat over there. Got a computer in his lap and some notes as he does some homework here. So Brooks was up here visiting with us before the game started, hanging around for a little bit up on the deck. Always nice to talk with Brooks as well. Knowing he's not on the air for you folks joining us from the Binghamton area or Black Bears fans, welcome into the Watertown Wolves broadcast. Wolves get the puck into the offensive end early here tonight. The Wolves were very aggressive last evening. A lot of pep in their step right off the bat, getting out to the early lead. Binghamton battled back, and the Wolves were able to come right back and score the win. It was a tough one, but got the job done. Puck control near side. Anderson sends it right back to center ice. Fitzgerald cross ice onto the stick of Austin Thompson, plays it right back into his own end.
A delayed penalty, so Egbert to the bench. Watertown's going to go shorthanded early tonight. It's been a problem for him all year, taking bad penalties at bad times. And less than a minute into the game, they're going to go shorthanded, and it's Tate Leeson who's going to come sit down.
So after the touch-up by Pavlov, we get the stop in the action. Just over a minute played here in the first period. And Wolves going on the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill. Face off to the far circle. It's going to be Trevor Lord skating into the circle. Steven's going to skate in on the other side. And my apologies, that was Jacob Black took the face off. Wolf's shorthanded effort here. Carter Thornton steps inside, got knocked down at the blue line, was able to shovel the puck a little bit further, but it's picked up, taken away there. Connor Smith's going to carry out, slides it to the near side, got it to Somero, who slides it to Steven. Steven steps inside the zone, stops outside the left circle, the right circle. I'm on the wrong side of the ice. Slides it back to Connor Smith, came in, lets a shot go. That hit a body in front. Rebound came right back out to the near circle. Stone gathers it up. He'll go to the slot. Slides it all the way across to the far side. Cameron Clark has it. Back to Smith in the slot. Lets a shot go. That hit a leg in front. Going to be gathered up by Steven on the near side. Slides it down deep into the zone to Somero. Back to Stone. Stone looks cross ice. Connor Smith controls. Comes right back through the slot. Slides it in front. Turned aside by Kozlowski. Big blast coming. That one again redirected to the corner. Smith gathers it up near side. He'll just risk one towards the goal. And the Wolves able to take this one, not clear it, but it'll be settled down by Black as he's able to send it out as Watertown will clear and go for a change. Daniel Stone back behind his own goal, settles down the puck, looks to carry it out. Far side, gets outside the zone, drop pass back there. For Gavin Yates. Yates, he overskated it, had to come back for it, but he'll get it forward to Tyson Kirkby, inside the line, coming to the short slide area. Thompson winds up, lets a shot go, missed on the near side. Yates with the rebound, steps to the far side, 22 seconds left in the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill, and the Watertown Wolves able to clear this one down the length of the ice. So Nolan Egbert way out of the goal, will settle the puck down, he'll leave it for Dakota Bond. Long stretch pass for Thompson. Into the offensive end, just 5 seconds left to go in the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill. Centering pass in front, they score! Well, I'll tell you what, Blake Tosta was just signed a couple of days ago, and he's got his third power play goal of the weekend, all against the Watertown Wolves. He had two goals last night, and now another power play goal here just at the end of the Leeson penalty.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if this one is credited power play goal or not, but either way, right, you know, before Leeson had a chance to get onto the ice, and Kirkby able to find Tosto in front, who just shovels it home.
Puck carried around behind, sent out on the far side, skips by everybody. Thornton back to pick it up for the Black Bears, and another penalty is coming very quickly. Looks like Josh Fletcher will be the guilty party. Highstick will be the call. So he'll come over and sit down. So two quick penalties here in the early going. We talked a little bit last night about temper started to flare towards the end of it. There was a couple of fights that we had. Kind of expected that kind of atmosphere here this evening. And I believe the officials may be trying to set the tone a little bit early. Carried out far side, looking up the ice. Liam Anderson dumps that one all the way in. And then Grasby couldn't get to it on the near side, had to reach back, pulls it back under him. And now he'll look up ice for the Watertown Wolves. Grasby coming up through center, steps inside the zone, goes to the far point, drops it down to Tate Leeson. Leeson turning there on the top of the right-hand circle, looks towards the front of the goal. He's got Merck standing right there, tried to slide it to the front of him. It came back to Leeson. He'll get it back to Trevor Lord. Grasby in the slot, settles down the puck, goes to Mercurio far side. Mercurio back in front. Leeson lost it for a second, and Somero able to send that one the distance, right on goal. So out of the goal is Kozlowski, sends that one forward to Trevor Lord with a quick shot off the glass behind. Trevor Lord looking for the rebound in behind, gave it to Tate Leeson. Leeson back to Grasby. Grasby winds up, slides it down to Lord, and Lord's just going to play that one behind. Gamzatov picks it up there, gives it right back on the near side to Trevor. Puck came back out through neutral ice. Dumped all the way down into the Watertown end. one's going to get lifted off a stick and up and out of play. My apologies. I'm trying to figure out. I have some kind of a rubbing noise going something on here. I don't know if I'm catching the mic on my jacket or what the case may be, but getting some kind of a interference there. Fletcher up to his feet with just 28 seconds left in the Watertown man advantage. Flanagan, quick shot, put it on, hit a body in front, easily cleared away down the ice by Jesse Anderson. Wolves able to pick it up here, just 13 seconds left in the man advantage. Jake Black carries it out, steps inside the blue line, goes right towards the front of the goal, stops now on the left-hand side, try to slide it back to the point. That's going to skip right by Flanagan. He'll have to give chase. Penalty is over. We are back to all even. Puck turned over, defensive zone, picked up by Gavin Yates. Yates slides it in front, broken up. Quick shot coming on the far side, knocked down by Kozlowski. Came back to Daniel Stone. He'll put this one on. That hit a body, and it goes right through to Kozlowski. He'll smother it, and we get a stop in play. That's going to take us to our first media timeout here in period number one. 1-0 your score. The Black Bears with the early lead.
There's cheese on a burger, and then there's cheese on a cheeseburger. Too much? Nah, don't miss the Red Robin Cheese Lovers lineup.
Red Robin.
Yum.
My Northern experience started with my mom, and I'm passing that on to my daughters.
I opened my first credit union account when statements were chiseled in stone.
Having a debit card is great because my mom can just deposit money through her account into my account.
Having the money to get food when we go on sports trips or paying our parents or grandparents back when they buy us something.
I love having all three generations of my family with Northern Credit Union.
I trust Northern Credit Union because I know that they're going to take care of us as if we are family.
Advanced Documents from ABS offers several exclusive and advanced features to support you in creating the workflow you need with.
Hey, my name's Paige, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the crispiness of the breading and the tenderness of the filet. It's tasty, it's warm, it's total satisfaction.
Hi, this is Tanya, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that warm bun, the perfectly seasoned chicken, and that pickle. Woo! I love it. There's a taste of my childhood in every bite.
So out of our first media timeout of the evening, offensive zone faceoff for the Binghamton Black Bears, just killing off their first penalty kill of the evening. Faceoff one back to the corner. Picked up there and carried around the backside by Kyle Steven. He'll get knocked down on the far side. No call coming from the officials. Leeson lost it for a second. Wolves had to reach back, gathered up. Lincoln Gingrich, his pass hit a leg, goes deep into the Watertown zone. Declan Flanagan back to pick it up. Slends that back out to center ice. It's settled down there by Connor Smith. He'll slide it to Dan Stone. Stone steps inside, gets it to Uturo with a quick shot. Easily turned aside by Kozlowski. And now back the other direction. Mercurio jumps into the offensive end. Tried to slide it to Leeson near side. That was broken up by Stone and sent back towards the Watertown end. Icing will be the call as the puck slips by on the near side. And they'll skate it back down to the other end. So the Wolves are going to head out on the road next weekend. They will go to Danbury, Connecticut on Friday evening to face the Hattricks out there, and then a big crucial matchup on Saturday night at First Arena in Elmira, New York, as they'll take on the River Sharks. You can catch that game. Just go to the YouTube channel of the Elmira River Sharks, and you'll listen to John Clement on that broadcast. Wolves right back towards the front of the goal. Gamzatov left it there on the doorstep. As I misspoke myself, puck rattled around the backside. Egbert able to find it at the last second. That thing was just bouncing around in the blue paint. This one's going to get carried along. Fletcher got it outside the zone, but Grasby gathers it up. He'll look forward, tipped ahead by Ivan Sergeyev. Sergeyev, the big defenseman, jumps all the way into the offensive rush. Tried to slide it back towards the front of the goal. Gamzatov there couldn't find it. And the puck's coming back the other direction. Thompson skates inside. Got Anderson on the wing. Tried to slide it back to him. That was broken up. Kozlowski got knocked down in the process. Puck back the other direction. Pavlov drives it to the front, trying to get it to Gamzatov. One-timer. Egbert able to turn that one to the corner. And now it squirts back in front of the goal. That'll get sent the distance, and that'll get another icing call. It is Watertown the last minute now. A couple of good opportunities putting pressure on Nolan Egbert. Did a nice job of that last night in front of Connor McAnanima, picking up some goals. And tonight, looks like they picked up right in that same spot, putting some traffic in front and trying to draw some confusion. Fletcher's going to win that one off the faceoff back to his own end. Lifted way up into the air. William Goodbooth's going to settle it down for Watertown, though. Slides that one forward, tipped ahead by Carter Thornton. Chase for the loose puck. Black gets there first. And then Carter Thornton couldn't get his stick in on the play. Gingrich pinches in, keeps it in the offensive end. Centering pass broken up by Kirkby. He'll just lift that one down, and giving chase to go pick it up will be Goodbooth. Settles in behind the Watertown goal, looks up from there. Wolves look to set up their offense. Three Black Bears in on the forecheck, but this sent right out to neutral ice, gathered up by Carter Thornton. His pass to the far side for Grasby was too far. Huge hit on the far side. Dakota Seaman just absolutely leveled Fitzgerald, and Fitzgerald hobbles back towards the bench as Leeson gets behind the defense, and a huge save by Nolan Edgert. Tate Leeson did a beautiful job getting the puck to the backhand, just couldn't get it up into the air, and now a crossing pass gets knocked down, intercepted. Jesse Anderson back the other way, puts a shot on Kozlowski, leathers that one, and hold on, and we get another stop in the action. Tate Leeson did everything right, but get that shot a little higher off the ice. A very nice move getting towards the front of the goal.
No, spot on, Jeff. I mean, how many times do you see somebody get in behind like that, and all they need to do is elevate the puck? That's the hardest part once you get onto the backhand, especially. Down here.
Fell off the faceoff, a little pushing and shoving, and it looks like we'll try it one more time. And
couple of friendly slashes.
So they'll try it one more time. Face-off control by Watertown. Grasby skated out from behind. Got it to Mercurio. Drops it to Leeson near side. Just going to rifle one towards the goal. That's going to go high off the netting behind. And another stop in play. And they'll bring the face-off back to the near circle. For the Binghamton Black Bears, they will head out to the Midwest next week. On Friday night, they will head to Port Huron, Michigan to take on the Port Huron Prowlers. And then they've got a big game with the Motor City Rockers, and Watertown scores! William Goodbooth, the defender for Watertown, his second goal of the week and third on the season for William Goodbooth, and the Wolves knotted up with 11:10 left to go in the opening period here from Watertown.
Yeah, take a look. This is a carbon copy of the goal Goodbooth scored last night. Just stepped into one from the blue line and threw a traffic in front. I mean, three or four bodies and screened the goalie. Egbert couldn't see it tonight. McAnanima last night. Goodbooth answers right back. Watertown all tied up.
Back the other direction, quick shot coming from Anderson. That hit a stick, never got all the way through. He'll pick it up from there. Wolves take it right back, though. Sergeyev near side, now he'll go cross ice. Got it onto the stick of Lindbergh. Garrick Lindbergh to the front of the goal, puck bouncing around. Nobody in a blue sweater able to take advantage of the puck back the other direction. Thompson reaches back, drags it in. Whoa, he rifled one off the pipes. Looks like he beat Kozlowski glove side, but it rang off the pipe and the puck back the other direction. Vladislav Pavlov very to care of that one forward. And now we get a stop in play. And Wolves are going to get a power play out of this. coming over to sit down, Austin Thompson. And I missed the play, or the call, but away from the play, but interference was the signal from the official. So the Wolves are going to get their second power play of the evening. And Connor, remind me, correct me if I'm wrong, but last night I think I was in the middle of giving out the schedule for both teams next weekend when Good Boot scored last evening. Maybe I'll just do it every time he's on the ice tonight.
Yeah, that was eerily similar. I mean, just same spot on the ice. I mean, opposite end, but stepped into the wrister from the blue line. And look out.
Yeah, outlet pass intercepted. Somero got behind the defense, but Wolves able to come back, break that up. Leeson's going to carry it forward. Drop pass for Gamzatov. Goes to the short slot area. Gave that shot to Trevor Lord. Somero's going to get the rebound. Just going to dump that one down the ice as he goes for a change. In on the forecheck is Fitzgerald, but it's played out to the near side by Kozlowski. Picking it up in stride is Tate Leeson. He'll come through center ice, had it poked away, and then back the other direction. Fletcher has it. Tried to get it back to Kyle Steven. Pass was behind him, so he'll just lift that towards the offensive end. Wolves pick it up from there. Trevor Lord comes through center ice, tried to slide it forward. Nobody there, so it's sent right back the distance with 55 seconds left in the power play for Watertown. Black steps into the offensive end, drags it down, stops at the corner, had it poked away, went to pick it back up. Now it's lifted way up into the air. That'll bounce down the ice with just 34 seconds left to go. Back to pick it up will be Declan Flanagan. He'll look up ice, stretch pass out to Carter Thornton. Thornton wheels back into the Watertown end, turning with it there. He'll skate up to the right-hand side, steps inside the blue line, puts the brakes on there, and left it and tried to slide it back to the slot and missed Declan Flanagan with it. So Flanagan had to race back, pick the puck up. He'll give it back to Dakota Seaman in the defensive end for Watertown. Power play is going to be over. We'll be back to all even. Broken up right out of the penalty box. Thompson picks it up. He'll get taken hard to the boards. Somero comes in to pick it up after that. And a quick shot from Stone goes off the side of the goal. Battle for the loose puck behind. Stone falling down. And that's going to take us to our second media timeout here. 1-1 is your score from Watertown. We'll be right back.
Honey, who's got the best deal on...
Bob Johnson!
Flower pots! The best deal on flower pots!
Bob Johnson doesn't have deals on flower pots. But we have the very best deals on new cars, trucks, and SUVs. Best inventory, best service, best pricing, best people. Bob Johnson, this is where the savings are.
Bob Johnson.
Bob Johnson.
Hi, I'm Scott Skinner.
Hi, I'm Ryan Skinner.
We own the Mustard Seed. We started in 1997 wanting to own our own small business. We got involved in the organic and natural food business, not knowing the lifestyle, what the foods were, and what a resource that this business offered to our community.
We found that there was a much bigger market for organic and natural foods in the Watertown area. The more that we provided as far as offerings in the store, the more business we received. The future of the Mustard Seed would look like expanding beyond Watertown, being able to reach customers all throughout the United States.
We have been with Watertown Savings Bank for 2 decades. The service, the ability for us to reach out at any time and talk to any member of the staff has created a very friendly environment for us to work back and forth with.
Individual.
Out of our second media timeout here, period number one, faceoff controlled by Watertown. Lincoln Gingrich sends the puck around the backside of the goal. Going back to pick it up. Gingrich came right back to it. Now he'll slip it out on the far side. Tyson Kirkby able to knock it down. He and William Goodboo get tangled up. Kirkby comes away with a loose puck, stops behind, tried to leave the puck there for Tosco. He does. Kirkby got it back. Quick shot, hit a leg. Now it goes all the way up to the near side. Thornton has it. And breaking a stick on the play with Sergeyev. So he'll head across for a new stick. He'll pick that one up. into the offensive end. Gamzatov trying to keep it in. It's going to get slid out to the near side through center ice. Mercurio couldn't get to it. He does go back and pick the puck up from there. He'll leave it on the far side, but Thompson will be the first one to get to it. And then it's carried back in by Watertown. Trevor Lord turning with it, avoids the check. Looks towards the offensive end again. Drag it through a couple of players, but then it's knocked down, taken away by Brody Thornton. And back the other direction we come. Fletcher steps in between a couple of players, slides it to the near side. A puck was loose in front. Nobody in a white jersey able to take advantage. Wolves back the other direction. Grasby steps inside, got it to Leeson. Leeson tried to give it back to the near side to Lord. That was broken up. Back into the offensive end for the Black Bears. Cameron Clark carried it along. Centering pass coming. That's knocked down by Kozlowski. Stretch pass broken up. Anderson knocked it down at neutral ice. He'll swing back towards his own end. Slide just to Fitzgerald. Gave it right back to Anderson. He'll look up ice. Plays that one hard. Broken stick coming to Thompson. He tried to hack across the stick of Grasby. Broke his own stick. Penalty is coming for the slash. It'll get touched up. That's just adding insult to injury. You take a huge slash against a Watertown player and you break your own stick in the process.
Yeah, usually it's the reverse of that, right? Is you break somebody else's stick and get called for the slash, not break your own stick and get called for it. So that was kind of backwards of how it normally goes, but.
So the Wolves are going to get their third power play of the first period. 'Jacob Black going to skate into the circle for the Watertown Wolves. Tyson Kirkby flips side of that. Faceoff ends up underneath Kirkby and then taken away by Fletcher. He's able to skate out with it. Dumps it to the offensive end, and then Fletcher goes down to the ice. All by his lonesome. Not sure what happened there, but he walked back out of the zone gingerly, and the Wolves going to send that one down the length, and we'll get an icing call. So the third power play of the night, the Wolves improving on the power play numbers last night. Need to have more of that here this evening. Face off back into the Watertown end. We'll go to the far side. Tyson Kirkby having an extended conversation with the officials. Watertown controls off the draw. Carrying it out far side, getting tripped up with Josh Tomasi, and the Wolves are going to get a 5-on-3 here.
We're
going to get offsetting penalties, so.
They got Leeson last night for a dive, and they get Tomasi this time. And I think he might have just given Tomasi a 10. As Josh is headed back to the room for Watertown, so.
Now Trevor Lord looking for an explanation
from
the officials. Obviously somebody's got to come over to the box for Watertown, serve the penalty for Tomasi. So Thompson already in the box. He's got another minute 29 on his slashing penalty. Now 2 minutes up on the board each side. One for Samaro for the trip, and Tomasi sent off. His penalty not listed yet, but there is the tripping to Justin Samaro listed up on the board.
Say it's a little unusual. The conversations happen over by the benches. Normally it's down here in front of us, and it's going to migrate that way. Hemming's going to come over and sit down for Watertown to serve the penalty.
So Tomasi, you were absolutely right. 10-minute misconduct, abuse of the officials. So So we'll skate 4-on-4 for the next minute and 14 seconds. Face off back into the Black Bears end, then lift it out. This one's going to go the distance. Icing will be waved off. Back to pick it up. Watertown settles in behind. Still 1 minute left in the 4-on-4.
It's 5-on-4, I think, Jeff.
Yeah, I think you're right.
To be honest with you, I'm trying to count. It's not my strength, but
I think I caught somebody in a line change when I was looking across the ice. So 5-on-4 here. Quick shot coming. They score! Tate Leeson will add goal number 34 on the season for the captain. And Watertown back to a lead now for the first time this evening. 2-1.
Leeson on the power play. Something that worked in the early part of the season. Seems like Watertown's gotten away from that a little bit here, but give Tate a chance to step into a shot. I mean, that's never a great idea.
When looking at that replay from Steve Weed Productions, and give Alexander Gamzatov credit too, standing right in front of Nolan Egbert. He had no idea where the puck was. And something the Wolves have done really well this weekend is to put pressure on the goalkeeper and put a lot of traffic in front of him. Picked up near side, Gingrich got held down. Puck slides into the offensive end for Watertown, but it's picked up by Leon Anderson. He'll play it around the backside. Wolves able to keep it in the zone. Drop pass to the far corner, centering pass. Hit a body in front. Gamzatov's going to go pick it up. He'll slide it back out. Quick shot coming from Lindberg. That hit someone in front, never got all the way through. Loose puck in the corner, now controlled in the zone by Liam Anderson. He'll carry it out this time. Lifts it way up into the air. Gingrich took a swat at it with his hand, missed it. And that's going to allow for the puck to get into the corner. Brody Thornton there trying to pick it up. Wolves able to clear cross ice far side. Tosto back to pick it up for the Black Bears. We'll slide it back to the near side to Fitzgerald, who lifts it forward. Got it to Kirkby. Kirkby drop pass here, top of the circle. Yates very quickly skates around the backside. Turns and lets a shot go. Puck loose in front. Fanning on the shot was Kirkby. A beautiful centering pass. He took a giant swing at it and missed everything. This is going to come right through center. Sergeyev tried to play it forward, got tangled up with Anderson. And now the puck loose once again. Poked to the near side. Jake Black steps in, just going to lift one on goal. And that's gloved by Nolan Egbert. He sees a little bit of traffic coming. He'll hold on to it. We get a stop and play. And that'll take us to our final media timeout of period number one.
Sometimes the end, well, it's just another beginning.
Ed Robin.
Yum.
At Bob Johnson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown, goal number one is to be number one. To break volume sales records, we're clearing the lots with Bob Johnson pricing. During the President's Day sales event, lease the all-wheel drive 2024 Dodge Hornet RT, the most powerful compact utility vehicle, $299 a month. Bob Johnson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown. This is where the savings are.
Out of our final media timeout, period number one. 2-1 is your score. The Watertown Wolves enjoying a one-goal lead over the Binghamton Black Bears. Puck broken up at center ice, carried ahead by Gavin Yates. Steps in, avoids a check, lets a shot go. That one turned aside by Kozlowski. Yates got taken down to the ice after that. Penalty is coming to Watertown. It'll be Declan Flanagan on his way over to sit down. He'll get 2 minutes for the slash. He gave a little look to Yates over in the corner and looked at the official and gave the diving motion with his hands as he skated back towards the penalty box. The official just kind of gave him a little smile and they let that one go.
Yeah, you can see what Deck thought of it, obviously, but they have called a couple of dives here this weekend, but not that time on Yates.
Bond sends it down deep into the zone, right inside the circle. Kirkby lets a shot go. That one rattled around to the far side. Yates has got the rebound. He'll come through the slot, gave it back to Kirkby. Kirkby goes to Bond at the slot. He'll let a shot go. That hit a body in front, down on the ice, and they score.
Guess who?
Yeah. A power play goal to Blake Tosto. Four on the weekend. The rookie just signed with the Binghamton Black Bears a few days ago. He's got four goals this weekend, two here last night, two tonight, all power play goals for the young man.
Take another look at it. Gaz trying to fight through the screen from Thompson, makes the first save. Puck comes out in front, and Tosto once again to just suck the leftovers home. He's starting to make a habit of that. Watertown might need to reconsider their coverage there on shorthanded chances. I mean, put a body on him, even if it means letting somebody be open at the line maybe.
So the puck rattles around to the near side off the ensuing draw. Ivan Sergeyev has it, gave it back to the corner. Turning with it was Vladislav Pavlov. Sent that one deep in. Gamzatov got turned off the puck, but it came right back out. Held on to by Garrick Lindberg. Put it in front. That missed over the top of the goal as the Wolves put the pressure right back on. William Goodboot sends that one in, and that's going to get reached up and caught by Nolan Egbert. And as he reached out for that one, there was a Watertown stick came through trying to play the puck. Might have made contact with his hand, and a lot of the Bears taking exception to that, coming to the defense of their goalkeeper. No malicious intent there. That was somebody just trying to play the puck. Ends up making contact with Egbert. But obviously, you're going to come to the defense of your goalkeeper.
Absolutely. I mean, that's the way it works. Doesn't matter if it was an honest attempt or not. Defensemen never see it that way. It's just one of those things. You always stand up for your goaltender. And Egbert, I'm sure, will appreciate that from the Black Bears.
Quick shot coming, Carter Thornton off the faceoff, deflected up and out of play, and we'll try it one more time. Come right back to the same faceoff circle to the near side. Jake Black skating in for Watertown against Josh Fletcher. Fletcher's gonna win this one back through his feet, so it's controlled by Liam Anderson, hard off the glass, but Grasby sends it down and sends it right back to the offensive end. Black goes in, gave it to the near side. Centering pass coming. Oh, a huge save. Dakota Seaman was right there on the doorstep, and now Seaman's going to get tangled up in behind and immediately unloads a bunch of punches. Dakota Seaman had a beautiful opportunity to score, and it was a nice save by Nolan Egbert, and immediately Josh Fletcher grabbed a hold of him at the side of the goal. Not sure what that was all about, but I think Fletcher's going to think twice before he does that again, as Dakota Seaman just unloaded on him. Seaman with a little shimmy all the way back to the penalty box, and they both have a good laugh looking back and forth at each other. Not sure what that was all about. As I said, Seaman went to the front of the goal and tried to get a shot on goal. Fletcher turned around and grabbed him and spun him around, gave him a little shot, and then Seaman just unloaded a bunch of right hands in a hurry. They're both having a good laugh with this right now. They're looking back and forth, and they're having a conversation between the glass, and they're both laughing about it. Fletcher's there.
I genuinely can't tell if that's sarcastic or...
I don't know. I wish I could hear it, because it looks like they're having a great conversation. Both with big smiles on their face. Well, obviously both We'll be sitting for an extended period here.
Seaman's going to head back to the locker room. He's not sure what for, but... Not sure he can argue a ton about that necessarily, but less than 2 minutes to go here in the period. I mean,
so an extended conversation between players and officials here just outside the Black Bears zone.
Yeah, I think everybody's trying to figure out what all the fallout really is. That incident. But lost in all of this is, like you said, I mean, that's a golden opportunity for Seaman. It was right in front of the goal. Great feed pass across the blue paint to find him, and huge save from Nolan Egbert. I'm going to skate 5-on-5 after all that, so.
Well, good. Glad we could add to the confusion.
Everything's a wash, I guess.
Crasby able to take it off the draw, just sends that one in off the back. Dasher Leeson streaks in, tried to pick it up, got taken off the puck there. Sent out to the near side. Tosto lifted it forward. It was knocked down, never cleared the zone, and now it's loose behind the goal, but going to pick it up will be Brody Thornton for the Black Bears. He'll start their attack up the left-hand side, chased into the foreground, and lost it right there, and it skips outside the zone. He rattled it around the pipe, so the... Black Bears had to get back onside. 1:13 left to go in period number one. The Wolves content to set up their offense in behind the goal.
Well, they were doing that. Leeson and Kirkby were entangled.
Puck out to neutral ice. Mercurio had it for a second, lost it. Blake Tostel's going to end up with it. Skates back through his own end, tried to lift it forward to Tyson Kirkby. That was broken up by Trevor Lord. Lord plays it forward to himself down into the left corner. Drags it around the back, tries to slide it back to the near side. Gingrich has it, steps in, lets a shot go, put it in front. That was redirected but missed on the top of the cage. Vladislav Pavlov able to put a stick blade on it, I should say, but he missed. Now 27 seconds left. The Bears up the ice one more time. That one will get lifted in from Tosto. It's going to be an icing call, and we'll get a stop in action. 23 seconds left to go in the first 20 minutes of play here from Watertown.
Pavlov got crunched behind the goal by Kirkby, and then some more physicality. The game last night was full of that. It's been pretty rough and tumble first period here, too.
So Dakota Seaman got the 5 for fighting, but he also got a 10-minute aggressor penalty and an ejection. So that's the reason that Seaman is headed off the ice. As we said, I don't think... Quick shot, knocked down in front. Rebound came right back out in front. Another quick shot, missed on the top side. Yates with the rebound, carries that one around. Turns right there, and that's going to bring an end to the period. So all that happened on the side of the goal. Dakota Seaman had a great opportunity to score. Nolan Egbert with a stand-up save on the play. And then Fletcher took a shot at Dakota Seaman, and Seaman just turned around and unloaded on him. So they'll get him for the aggressor penalty and the game misconduct. And the period's going to end after 20 minutes of play. 2-2, we are knotted up between the Watertown Wolves and the Binghamton Black Bears. Both teams having extended conversations with the officials on their way back to the room. But that's the way the period will end. We'll take a short break here from Watertown.
My dog, Georgette, was diagnosed with cancer. After her treatment, we would pass Chick-fil-A. I started seeing Mr. Brian often. She would get her little treat of whipped cream.
We recognize each other, Georgette and I do. That particular day, Elaine pulls up. She said, Georgette is cancer-free.
I came around the corner with Georgette in my car, saw all the employees out there just like clapping and cheering. I started getting really emotional because I was just like, that's so nice.
We love all our customers that come through. This one just happens to have 4 legs. Congratulations, Georgette.
landscape of fitness was bleak. Toxic instructors, shady scammers, and Bispo Bakes.
Grandma shot.
Mother Fitness was angry.
Megan Thee Stallion.
Hello, my hot girl.
Enough of this toxic nastiness. So she took her hotties to the judgment-free zone. Welcome to Planet Fitness, where everybody can work out in their own way.
Listen to Mother Fitness and join today. Planet Fitness, big fitness energy for all.
Where are my legs?
Our tradition for my football team is we dress up, shirt and tie. I had a tie, but I didn't know how to tie it. Usually I would have my dad help me, but he was deployed. I'm thinking, don't worry about it. My grandma should know.
He says, can you tie a tie? And I'm like, no, but we're on our way to Chick-fil-A.
I recognize them because they came into our store so much. Miss Bertha and Mr. Terrence, I'm like, of course, I'll help them out and show them how to tie a tie.
It wasn't just the tie, it's what was in your heart.
It's my pleasure. Mm-hmm. Doing good, man. You got it.
There's cheese on a burger, and then there's cheese on a cheeseburger. Too much? Nah, don't miss the Red Robin Cheese Lovers lineup.
Red Robin.
Yum.
My Northern experience started with my mom, and I'm passing that on to my daughters.
I opened my first credit union account when statements were chiseled in stone.
Having a debit card is great because my mom can just deposit money through her account into my account.
Having the money to get food when we go on sports trips or paying our parents or grandparents back when they buy us something.
I love having all three generations of my family with Northern Credit Union.
I trust Northern Credit Union because I know that they're going to take care of us as if we are family.
Advanced Documents from ABS offers several exclusive and advanced features to support you in creating the workflow you need with minimum time and effort. Capture scanned documents as well as documents generated by other applications. Process the documents using barcode readings, converts text to digital and searchable documents, and stores the document where you determine it go. Contact our specialists at ABS for a no-cost assessment today to learn how Advanced Documents can take your business to the next level and streamline your processes.
Longhorn steak so legendary? Some say it's our flavor-packed signature seasonings. Some say it's how we pair them with our juicy, tender steaks. And some just say, Hurry in tonight for Longhorn's legendary flavors. Our new limited-time blackened salmon with our smoky 18-ounce outlaw ribeye and our rich and savory flo's filet. That's how steak is done. Longhorn Steakhouse. You can't fake steak.
We went to another financial institution for a mortgage rate. And when we brought that to Northern, they said they would either match it or beat it. And they matched it at first, and then they even went lower and they beat it. So we decided to go with Northern for our mortgage.
Before we bought this house, we were living separate. So he would drive 2 hours to come see me in Vermont. I would drive 2 hours to come see him in New York, and this gave us a spot in the middle, so we actually get to see each other every day now.
From your head to your shoulders and your knees to your toes, North Country Orthopedic Group has you covered. The most trusted name in orthopedics is now seeing patients at Claxton Hepburn and performing surgeries at Claxton Hepburn Medical Center and Carthage Area Hospital. The highest quality of medical care you've come to expect, now closer to home. North Country Orthopedic Group, covering you from head to toe.
Got a burger here.
Red Robin, you get all the fulls.
Red Robin.
Yum.
where bottomless steak fries are free with every burger.
Some things never go out of style, but doing all your banking in person? Not even. Let's get digital with Northern Credit Union. It's like totally rad.
Let's get digital.
Apply for a new car loan in online and mobile banking and get that sweet new DeLorean with a gnarly sound system.
Wanna get digital.
Or get digital with Northern Credit Union by applying for a mortgage right from your phone.
Let's get digital.
Don't get stuck in the past. Get digital with Northern Credit Union.
A house isn't just a place, it's a trove of memories. It's not just a structure held together by nails and screws. It's a sanctuary for family and friends, a place to celebrate, commemorate, and nurture. At Northern Credit Union, we believe that a house is a home, and your new home is just waiting for you to fill it with memories. Apply for a loan today with Northern Credit Union, because your why is our why.
My name is Casey Hughes, and I am a nurse with Samaritan Home Health. I was fortunate enough to have great mentors during nursing school and throughout the start of my nursing career. There are so many different ways to serve your community, whether it's in a hospital setting, home care, an office. I think that new nurses should choose Samaritan because of all of the opportunities that we are given. Take care of our community and your future.
Welcome to Five Star. Let me show you around. Our mission here at Five Star is to ensure our customers get the best results. The first step in this process is asking the right question. This process allows us to make the right recommendations for the products that are going to work for you and not recommend products that will not work for you. Now, let's talk a little bit about the products. When it comes to ensuring better results for our customers, our products matter. That's why we source a wide variety of vendors to ensure bringing in the most cutting-edge products that deliver results for our customers. Now, the final piece of the puzzle is accountability. When shopping at Five Star, you're given the opportunity to get free in-body readings every time you come in. This allows us to track how much muscle you're gaining, how much body fat you're losing, and paints a full picture of all the results you're accomplishing. We're so confident in our ability to make the right product recommendations that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee, no questions asked.
In the spirit of judgment freedom, Planet Fitness went to Olympia, Washington to honor all, what people from that city get called. You know the way people from Boston get called Bostonians? People from Olympia, Washington get called, you know what I'm talking about. We wanted to sponsor those. Everyday those, regular those, all kinds of those. Anyways, our lawyers told us we had to make it extremely clear that we are not endorsing or sponsoring any international sporting event or affiliated athletes. We just believe that to be celebrated, you don't have to be an elite physical specimen who trains their entire life and competes in their chosen sport at the highest level all through their childhood and adolescence, and then represents their country on a world stage to compete for one of three different colored accolades. We believe that to be celebrated, you just need to join Planet Fitness.
Delaney Kuttner here with Mike from Kraft 836 Canteen.
NNY Eats, featuring Kraft 836 Canteen.
Mike, tell us a little bit about the name and the meaning behind it.
Sure, Delaney. Craft to us means to make or produce by hand with care, skill, and creativity.
So let's head into the kitchen and check it out. We're here in the kitchen with Cody, who's gonna tell us how to make one of this place's best-selling dishes. So what are we making, Cody?
Make a sand flat scampi today.
And that's what I call slow food faster. All right, so Michael, tell us a little bit about what's going on over here.
So we fresh squeeze our juices here at Kraft. We wanna use fresh, because fresh is what? Fresh is best.
Mike, I was gone for 2 minutes. How did all this get here?
Well, while you were gone, I just scanned the menu and ordered everything from my phone, and the staff has been serving to our table as we've been sitting here.
For slow food faster, check out Kraft 836 Canteen. And check out more NNY Eats on informnny.com. Let's dig in. Delaney Kuttner here with Kyra Fetla at Carthage Area Hospital, and this is Health Beats. So Kyra, you work in the physical therapy department here, and you guys offer a wide range of services, including preventive care.
Physical therapy is not only restorative, but it can be proactive to prevent injuries from happening or to reduce the burden that you are already experiencing.
But that being said, you guys do help restore people who are already experiencing issues.
We treat a wide range range of conditions, including after surgery, across the lifespan for babies all the way up to geriatrics. Anything that is impacting your ability to move and live in a functional way, we can help assess.
So where can people go so they can get treated by your services and come and visit your department?
The easiest way is to go to your primary care physician and ask for a referral to physical therapy. But as a physical therapist in the state of New York, I can treat people direct access, which means I can see you for 10 visits or 30 days, whichever comes first, before we need your primary care to sign off on it.
So you can find more information on CarthageHospital.com and more health beats on InformNNY.com.
Hi, I'm Tony Mangano.
Hi, I'm Carmen Emmy.
We're the partners at the Hampton Inn Watertown. We have a long family history in being in business. Started with our grandfather in the early 1950s. He started a small farm in central New York. He sold produce to grocery stores. We had a little roadside farm market that we sold from. Eventually, the family business expanded into the hotel business. It came time for us to start our own projects, and Watertown was the first place we looked.
With the help of Watertown Savings, we have three Hiltons in Syracuse and one here now in Watertown. Built this hotel and then bought the one across the street a year later.
We have 90 guest rooms here, an indoor swimming pool, fitness room, and a meeting room.
We contacted Mark Bellinger at Watertown Savings Bank, and immediately after our conversation with Mark, we knew that we wanted to work with him. He listens to our plan, he asks great questions.
And he's mostly our direct line, but honestly, we do deal with other people in the organization. Terry Millott, Mark LaVarnway, and every one of them, it's the same thing. Fantastic service always.
They make you feel like you're their only customer. You don't find that with the larger institutions. We've been down that road before and it's not there.
It's the gospel truth. It's easy to glow about them because just so down to earth and personable and very approachable always. And like Carmen said, you really feel like you're their only customer when you're talking to them.
Chick-fil-A.
I go to that Chick-fil-A all the time.
He came in the drive-thru. Before I can give him his change, he drove away. It was a month before he came back in.
Marcus hands me this envelope, and it's like $3.
I kept it in my back pocket for over a month.
That's crazy. I'm just like pretty stunned.
He's like, dude, you're serious? What?
Appreciate the $3, man. Yeah. And we found out we both play trumpet.
Extra Life is a game-oriented fundraiser for Children's Miracle Network. Either this is our 12th year, or last year was our 12th year. I think this year is our 12th year. So, I mean, it's been, we've had as many as 100 people and as little as 2 people. So it really depends on. It's free to join. You don't have to make a commitment. We don't do any online streaming. It's all like in person. We will ask for donations and stuff on our Facebook pages and our Instagram. And that'll generate a little bit, but a lot of what we do is like just in-house. We try to make it as easy for people as we can. We don't, you know, if you want to join our team and you want to try to solicit some stuff outside of it and help us out, that's great. If you don't want to even make that commitment, pop by, drop us a $20 bill and, you know, be on your way. So, I mean, we have people pop in and they play a game for 10 minutes and they donate whatever they're going to donate and then it's just turned into like, we try to make it a community event. This year it will be on November. Extra Life is a game-oriented fundraiser.
Hey, welcome back inside the Watertown Municipal Arena. We just set for period number 2, tied up at 2 goals apiece after the first 20 minutes of play. My name is Jeff Barrett, along with Connor Alone and Steve Witt, bringing you tonight's game. Fans, Stop DWI New York reminds you to always stop and think before you drink. Local law enforcement is cracking down on DWI offenders. Walk, ride, carpool, call a sober driver, have a plan, don't drive, get a ride. It's funded by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration with a grant from the New York State Governor's Traffic Safety Committee. Looking at the stats after the first 20 minutes of play, 11 shots on goal, dead even at 11 each, 9 saves on either side of the ice. Binghamton 1-for-1 on power plays, and Watertown 1-for-3 with the extra man. So I said Blake Tosto had 2 power play goals. That second one, obviously, after the penalty was over, just slightly over, but so it wasn't a power play goal. Looking ahead at the Watertown schedule, next Friday and Saturday, the Wolves are on the road. They'll go to Danbury, Connecticut on Friday night to take on the Danbury Hattricks, 7:30 in Danbury Arena. And on Saturday night, they'll head to Elmira to take on the River Sharks at 6:07 in First Arena. Back home on April 5th, 6th, and 7th, 5th and 6th, it'll be the Elmira River Sharks here in the building. And then on Sunday evening, the 7th, once again, the Binghamton Black Bears will be here one more time. So both teams making their way back out onto the ice. We get set for the second period of play. Pretty fun game to watch so far. The up and ground tempo has been very good. Both teams with a couple of goals each and some outstanding goaltending at either end as well.
Yeah, 2-2 could be worse than that for sure for both teams. So. Lord's having a conversation. As he skates over to the near side. Tomasi's in the box to start for Watertown and Fletcher for Binghamton.
Before we get started here, I got to give a shout out to my buddy Bobby Howard. Bobby, the Power Play post show host, podcast, and writer and radio personality down in the Binghamton area. Missing the action this weekend when they were down in Binghamton. The family emergency in the hospital. I won't get into that. That's a kind of a personal matter. We'll just leave it at that. But want to give a shout out to Bobby and his family. Let them know we are thinking of them. Back to action we go. Kirkby tips this one. It's going to go right back into the Black Bears' end. Sliding back with Stone to pick it up. Slides it all the way across ice. Big hit near side. Kirkby got taken to the boards by Lord. Watertown right back to the attack. Backhanded by Grasby. Missed on the near side as the Wolves continue to put some offensive pressure on early here in period number 2. Puck rattles around the backside. Stone tried to clear it. Mercurio's going to end up with it. Had it poked off his stick and now slides it out to Gavin Yates far side. Gavin Yates steps in. Races towards the front. Slides it to Bond. His shot knocked down by Kozlowski. And the Wolves gather it up from there. So, as Connor and I just said, a very entertaining first period is going to pick up right where we left off. Both teams with a couple of quick opportunities. Back the other direction, Uturo slides it forward to Kyle Steven. Cross ice. That one sent right on. Uturo trying to get to the rebound, had it broken up. Steven has it, slides it to the front of the goal, trying to get it in front. Uturo raced right back around. He'll battle for the loose puck. Wolves come away with it. Good boot out to the near side. Fletcher knocked it down, but it does square it out to neutral ice. Smith's going to play it hard off the boards to the far side. Broken up from there, came back to the near side. Smith steps in, and Kyle Stevens going to beat him by a step, and they'll get the whistle, and we'll try it one more time. Offside will be the call. So Fletcher in the box for the fight right before the end of the period. Tomasi serving the penalty. That was Dakota Seaman picked up for the fight. And then Seaman, of course, the game misconduct and ejected from the game. Played hard off the boards, but Thompson's going to grab it for the Black Bear sends it right back to the offensive attack. Clark had it, takes it away. He'll carry it out from behind, lost it on the way behind the Watertown cage, and able to skate out with a near side is Vladislav Pavlov. He'll lift it cross ice. Nobody there, so it's settled down by Anderson. He'll come back to the other Anderson, the near side, is Jesse Anderson to Liam Anderson. Liam takes it down to the offensive end, plays it to himself off the backboard, tried to slide it out in front. That one broken up, hard off the boards to the far side. Nico Hemming tried to play it, got taken away, and now pressure by the Wolves. Carter Thornton almost ended up with it. Came out through center ice. Wolves had to get back onside. Grasby drags it down to the right circle. Puts a shot on, rebound out in front, and the rebound shot over the top of the goal. Watertown missing a golden opportunity. Trevor Grasby, far side, settles it down, plays it off the boards to Jake Black behind that, broken up and able to go back the other direction. Brody Thornton very quickly got it to Yates. Yates back in front to Thornton, his shot redirected over the top of the cage. Battle for the loose puck. Yates has it near side, tried to slide it in front to Tosto. Now he'll just drag it out to the side, let a shot go. Kirkby couldn't get the rebound. Jackson Bond ends up with it, sends it down deep into the zone. Got it out to Yates, top of the left circle. Yates wheels around, looks to the far side, got hung up going in and got knocked down. No call coming from the officials. Yates kind of looking for the hook. I thought maybe we would see that called, but nothing up from the officials. The Wolves put one on here, and then a long outlet pass from Nolan Egbert, and he's going to get his own icing call. The AT got tied up going to the goal, got hooked and went down, and immediately started looking for the official call. Nothing was made.
Yeah, I agreed with you, Jeff. I thought for sure we were going to see a hook right there, but not to be. Watertown maybe dodges a penalty there.
Dakota Bond brings it out of the defensive zone. Got tangled up at center. Lost the puck there. I think I called him Jackson Bond a second ago. I do apologize about that. Carried around from behind. Garrick Lindberg had it taken away. Couldn't clear the zone. Kirkby slides it right back in front and standing on the doorstep was Cameron Clark with the one-time opportunity. He got tangled up with Spencer Kozlowski. And my apologies, that's Andrew Turturro that was standing in the blue ice. They got tangled up with Spencer Kozlowski. So face off to the left-hand side. Kyle Stevens stepping in for the Black Bears against Trevor Lord. Off the faceoff, Smith controlled, sent it to the corner, broken up there, and then lifted out to the far point, stays in the zone, quick shot coming. Wolves trying to clear, but it's knocked down, kept in the zone. Kyle Steven has it. He'll play it to the near side. Yuturo kept it along the boards. Now it gets taken away. Tate Leeson able to skate back the other direction, steps inside the zone, got it to Mercurio near side, tried to put it back in front. Leeson, no angle to get a shot off there, so it's controlled by Daniel Stone. He'll play it to Smith. Smith lost it off the skate. Wolves able to dump it right back to the offensive end. Lindbergh's just going to dump it. He'll go for a change. Stone looking to clear far side, slid that one forward to Yuturo, who knocked that one into the offensive end. Puck controlled behind, skating around. Connor Smith had it, played it up the far boards. He'll get knocked down in behind the play. Vladislav Pavlov and Thompson battling for the loose puck. Wolves coming away with it. Declan Flanagan able to bring the puck up to the left-hand side, dumps it all the way around the back dasher. Played off the hands, knocked down, tried to slide it back in front. Was Vladislav Pavlov, had that one broken up, and it does skip outside the blue line. He'll play that all the way back into the Watertown end. Lindbergh able to lift that one forward. Anderson knocks it down. Jesse Anderson slid it around to the near side. Fletcher touched it forward. Clark will give chase in behind the Watertown goal. Put it back out in front. Thompson with a shot, and that's off the stick of Spencer Kozlowski, and up and out of play. That's going to take us to our first media timeout of period number two. We'll be right back here in Watertown.
Hey, my name's Paige, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is the crispiness of the breading and the tenderness of the filet. It's tasty, it's warm, it's total satisfaction.
Hi, this is Tanya, and what makes the Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich original to me is that warm bun, the perfectly seasoned chicken, and that pickle. Woo! I love it. There's a taste of my childhood in every bite.
Honey, who's got the best deal on...
Bob Johnson!
Flower pots! The best deal on flower pots!
Bob Johnson doesn't have deals on flower pots. But we have the very best deals on new cars, trucks, and SUVs. Best inventory, best service, best pricing, best people. Bob Johnson, this is where the savings are.
Bob Johnson.
Bob Johnson.
So back inside the Watertown Municipal Arena, out of the first media timeout of the second 20 minutes. Face off to the far circle in the Watertown end. And just as quickly as they'll drop it, we'll try it one more time. Cameron Clark into the faceoff circle for the Black Bears against Jake Black for Watertown. Puck stays in the Watertown end, turning with it near side was Lincoln Gingrich. He'll slide that around the back. Wolves look to clear here. Centering pass came to Connor Thornton. He just lifts that one across ice, giving chase. Was Black, tried to slide it back in front to Carter Thornton. That one broke up. Clark back the other direction. Anderson on the right wing. They had a 3-on-2 opportunity, but the Wolves recovered very well to get back on the defensive end. Clark knocks it down from behind. Centering pass coming. Fanning on the shot was Thompson as he came through, standing right in front of the Watertown goal. Centering pass coming. That played off the skate. Goes to the corner. Picked up by Nico Hemming. He'll slide it to the near side and then lifted forward by Gary Lindberg as the Wolves were able to clear. Yates has it, tips it forward to the offensive end, and that will go for an icing call, and we'll get a quick stop in play. 13:08 left to go here in period number two. Josh Tomasi finally done serving the penalty to Dakota Seaman. He'll head over to the Watertown bench. So we talked about the Watertown schedule next weekend and the following weekend. For the Binghamton Black Bears, they will head out to Port Huron, Michigan next Friday evening. They'll take on the Port Huron Prowlers, and then they'll slide over to Fraser, Michigan for a Saturday night matchup against the Motor City Rockers on Saturday evening. That should be an entertaining contest there. 2-2 your score here. Yates backs it into the offensive end. Tried to get it to the front of the goal, lost it. Now he slides it back out in front. Utero with a shot. That one taken away, and the Wolves able to lift that one out. Foot race here for the loose puck. It's going to be an icing call. Trevor Lord couldn't get there quick enough. He's trying to argue the point that he was interfered with, trying to get to the loose puck. Obviously, the argument's going to fall on deaf ears. The official just skates away. Lord and Anderson have a good laugh going back up the ice together. So Lord to the faceoff circle against Tyson Kirkby. Lord's going to win that one back to the corner. Trevor Grasby grabs it up for Watertown, skates out in front of the Watertown goal. He'll look forward, plays it hard off the boards to Tate Leeson. Leeson tried to get it to Mercurio, just a little too far to get. Anderson back to pick it up, plays it along the boards. It hit a skate, came right back out in front. And before Yates could get to it, the Wolves head right back to the offensive end. Mercurio tried to get a little cute with that one, slide it through the feet of Brody Thornton. That didn't work. And now Gavin Yates, a foot race to the other end. ends up, he'll wrap right around, lets a shot go, and into the belly of Kozlowski, who holds on, and we get another stop in play. 11:58 left to go here in the second period. One game earlier this afternoon in the Fed, and if I could get to my scoreboard quickly enough here, which I can't seem to because I am way messed up here tonight, I'll get that to you in just a second. Yep, I'm on the ball on this Sunday evening, Connor. Back the other direction. Kyle Steven puts the brakes on, comes to the slot, lets a shot go. That off the pads of Kozlowski, and then he had to drop down and cover it as it rebounded a few inches out in front of him. And with a bunch of white jerseys right there in the vicinity, he'll think better of that, and he'll cover that one up. As we said, one other game in the FPHL this afternoon, it was the Columbus River Dragons hosting the Motor City Rockers at home, and Columbus with a 4-3 win against the Rockers this afternoon. Vladislav Pavlov breaks up the centering pass, tried to clear it, got it out to the near side. Gamzatov had he and Stone digging along the boards for the loose puck. Pavlov's going to come away with it, had to skate around a stick, tried to go cross ice. Zomero knocked it down, carries it back to the offensive rush as, excuse me, Pavlov goes over and broke that up. Wow. Centering pass coming. Kyle Steven couldn't get to it. I do apologize. I'm just getting over kind of a rough cold. Had a decent night last night on the mic. Tonight's a little bit rougher, but we'll keep battling along. I just apologize. Getting behind the defense. Anderson drags it down the near side. His shot right into the pads of Spencer Kozlowski. Koz holds on to that one. We get another stop in play. I think we'll all agree earlier this season, an issue for Watertown was letting guys get in behind the defense. And I'll tell you, the last month or so, the Wolves have improved 110% on that. Done a great job of matching up with players. Face-off controlled. Lincoln Ginger skates back behind the Watertown goal, played it out to the near side. Got it to Garrett Lindberg, slides it forward to Carter Thornton, his pass broken up. Thompson's going to run into his own player and lost the puck from there. Lindberg avoids a couple of checks, steps inside the blue line, lets his shot go. That one easily turned aside. Kept in by Anderson, centering pass right in front. Fitzgerald almost turned it back onto his own goalkeeper as he played it oddly off his stick. This one skips outside the zone, Wolves had to get back on. Jesse Anderson slides it around the back to Fletcher, and Fletcher's going to take a hit from behind, and Watertown's going to have a penalty call.
Yeah, pretty textbook board here. Watertown, again, shorthanded as we head to our media timeout. We'll be right back.
Sometimes the end, well, it's just another beginning.
Ed Robin.
Yum.
At Bob Johnson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown, goal number one is to be number one. To break volume sales records, we're clearing the lots with Bob Johnson pricing. During the President's Day sales event, lease the all-wheel drive 2024 Dodge Hornet RT, the most powerful compact utility vehicle, $299 a month. Bob Johnson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown. This is where the savings are.
Out of our media timeout, Wolves about to go on the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill once again. And Jake Black making that one a little easy for the officials. It gave a shot to Josh Fletcher from behind, stuffed him into the boards over here. So 2 minutes for roughing will be the call. Yates off the faceoff near side. Got tangled up, lost the puck for a second, got it back. Wolves out to the near side, and Mercurio able to clear the zone. He'll slide it past Bond down into the offensive end. Leeson giving chase as well. Tyson Kirkby has it, and he'll lift it to the near side. Yates going to have it skip by. Mercurio very quickly into the offensive end, helping take some time off this penalty along with Tate Leeson. Tyson Kirkby turns with it, gave it up to Yates. Yates goes cross ice. Tried to get it to Tosto, passes a little too far. Stays in the zone, though. Kirkby rattles that one all the way around the backside. Foot raised to the near side to pick it up. It's gathered by Trevor Grasby. He'll slide it around, and the Wolves able to lift this one out to a neutral ice area. Knocked down very quickly, and then sent right back in. As Yates couldn't get to the puck, Grasby just slapped it back to the Watertown offensive end. Carter Thornton tried to get to the front of the goal. Bond broke that one up. The Wolves almost had an odd man rush here. Back the other direction. Centering pass coming. Thompson, puck slid right out in front. And Kozlowski has to drop down and smother it to get a stop in play. 49 seconds left in the penalty kill for Watertown.
Yeah, Thornton almost put that one in on Kozlowski himself, and that would have been disastrous.
Off the faceoff, Ivan Sergeyev controls for Watertown. Cleared it out, not out of the zone. Stone net settled it down. Quick shot coming. It was off the shoulder of Kozlowski, and then this one will bounce the length of the ice. Egbert has to kneel down, stop that one as it went right in on goal. 30 seconds left in the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill for Watertown. Clark gets tangled up, getting out of the zone, got hauled down. No call coming from the official, and puck rebounds in the near side. Somero has it, drags it around the back, and now we're going to get a stop and play, and maybe we are going to get a penalty out of that. Nope, they're going to take a look at the goal. Looks like it came off.
Of course, last night they gave Kozlowski a penalty for that. So,
yeah, that goal at that end last night was a little bit suspect, coming off a couple of different times. And as you said, Kozlowski got to delay a game penalty. Off the faceoff, puck one to the corner, Wolves control, but the Black Bears keep it in the zone. And now Sergeyev able to just wheel back with it, lifts it out on the near side. Fletcher knocked it down. Wolves with a chance here, shorthanded effort. Leeson gets behind a couple of defenders, and a beautiful save by Nolan Edgar as Tate Leeson tried to go to the backhand again. Nolan Egbert hung right in there. Oh, a big save by Egbert, and the puck came right back out in front as the penalty is over. And it slipped right by Mike Mercurio, went right through his feet. I don't think Mercurio ever saw it. And now Watertown's going to get a power play out of this. One player down on the ice on the far side for Watertown. That is Tate Leeson, who's slow to get up. I didn't see it, but I heard the hit into the boards.
Yeah, Anderson got him kind of from behind after the play. And guessing he's going to hit. Penalized for that, probably an interference.
You know, no argument out of Jesse Anderson. He immediately reached over and gave Tate Leeson a little tap on the back, make sure he was okay. And now Leeson's going to come over to the penalty box.
They're going
to
get him for a dive again. Wow.
Well, when you get crushed from behind, your feet come off the ice, it is a dive.
Seen. I haven't seen that all year.
I know, and I'm being a little facetious.
Well, we haven't seen that all year until this weekend, right? I mean, there hasn't been at least here in Watertown, we haven't seen a dive called all season long, and now this weekend it's like it's some sort of point of emphasis.
And we've seen it on both sides of the ice. That's the curious thing. It's gone both ways. We've seen guys get knocked down, take huge hits, and also serve a penalty on the play. So – So Tate Leeson, the embellishment, Jesse Anderson holding will be the call.
Holding. Okay.
The Wolves looking to clear. Here's what we skate 4-on-4 now for the next minute 38 seconds. Very quickly, Mike Mercurio comes through center ice, drops it to Flanagan near side with a quick shot. Turned aside by Egbert. Rebound poked out in front, but nobody was there. In a blue jersey, Wolves gathered up. Carter Thornton drop pass to Mercurio. Far side of the left circle, slides it back in front. And with Carter Thornton standing right there, Nolan Egbert will scoop that one up. He'll hold on to it. We get a stop in play. 6:53 left to go, period number two. 2-2 is your score. Daniel Stone controls out behind his own goal. Off the draw, he'll lift it up the near side. It's tipped ahead by Garrick Lindberg. Wolves right back to the tap. Vladislav Pavlov drives down, puts a shot on. Egbert with the stick save. That one up into the netting and stops. And Watertown's going to get another offensive zone faceoff here. The Wolves seem to be enjoying the 4-on-4 skating the last couple of nights. When we've seen it, they've had a lot of opportunities. Enjoying the open ice. Turning with it, Daniel Stone got tangled up trying to clear the zone as Vladislav Pavlov took it back from him. Tried to slide it out in front. That was broken up. Puck down on the ice right in front. And Trevor Lord standing right there. And Nolan Egbert will deny him once again and get a stop in play with 47 seconds left in the penalties. One thing I'll tell you, I said it last night, I'll say it again tonight. Last night it was Connor McAnanima, tonight Nolan Egbert, but and Kozlowski at the other end for Watertown both nights. But one thing I will say as a hockey fan, I've enjoyed the goaltending the last two nights. Been great to watch at either end of the ice. 33 seconds left in the offsetting penalties. Black Bears look to escape the zone, step down onto the near side. Carrying it in was Connor Smith. He'll wheel back towards the blue line. Centering pass to Daniel Stone. That skipped right through. Couldn't get a shot off. He'll battle for the loose puck. Slides it behind. Bond went to pick it up. Tried to play it back behind. That hit a skate, and the Wolves able to skate out with it. Crasby through center ice. Steps inside the zone. Under 10 to go. He'll drag it back out to neutral ice. Crasby's going to carry it up, plays it to Black, near side, penalties are over, we're back to all even, and Gamzatov trying to get behind the defense, he'll leave it there for Black. Black tried to slide it out in front, it'll come to Lincoln Gingrich with a shot that hit a stick, went to the corner. Rebound played off the glass hard. Jesse Anderson just out of the box. Picks it up on the left-hand side. Battles all the way around the backside of the goal. Tried to leave it in front, but there's nobody there in a white sweater. Wolves right back the other direction. Trevor Lord plays it up to a huge save by Nolan Egbert. The goal was wide open. Trevor Lord had a wide open goal. Rifled it towards the gate, the cage. And Nolan Egbert diving back just threw his stick in front of the goal. And I just talked about spectacular goalkeeping. I just saw one of the best saves of the year. Give credit where credit is due. And hopefully we'll get a rebound or a replay of that in just a bit. Wolves able to clear this one back out to neutral ice. 4:34 left to go. And Trevor Lord's just got to be shaking his head on that one. He had a wide open goal and somehow able to get back and make a save was Nolan Egbert. Wolves had a good opportunity there on another one that missed across the top of the goal. Thornton back the other direction, had it knocked down by Trevor Lord. Lord tried to clear. Tyson Kirkby's going to end up with it. Kirkby turns. That one's going to get lifted down the ice. Icing waved off, so it's picked up. Sent back out to Gavin Yates. Drop pass here for Tyson Kirkby, who lifts it in the offensive end. Watertown settles the puck in behind their own goal. 3:48 left to go in the period. Watertown seems content to take some time off and now getting behind the defense. Gamzatov fanned on the shot. And he got tangled up as he tried to put a shot on goal from the centering pass from Jake Black. Now they're digging for the puck along the corner. Fletcher in there digging. Kirkby throws a stick in as well. And Yatesy also digging. Wolves able to come away with it. Came back out to the short slot area. Flanagan puts one on. That one turned aside by Nolan Egbert. Rebound came right back out in front. Yates back the other direction. Nifty move to get to the side. Slides it in front, and missing the side of the goal was Jesse Anderson off a beautiful feed from Gavin Yates. Kirkby goes over, picks it up, keeps it in the zone. On the far side, Wolves knock it down. Tomasi able to slide it cross ice to Sergeyev. That one was broken up. Tosto back the other direction. Left it for Yates in the corner. Yates skates around, centering pass broken down. Stone kept it in. His shot hit a body, never got all the way through. Tomasi able to lift that one forward. Into the Watertown end. Lifted high in the air, down the ice it will go. Bears back to the attack. Samuro behind the defense. Drop pass there. Carrying it in. It was Connor Smith. I apologize once again. Connor Smith tried to get it to the side. Daniel Stone puts a shot on. That's going to take us to our final media timeout. Good time for a break for me. We'll be right back.
My dog, Georgette, was diagnosed with cancer. After her treatment, we would pass Chick-fil-A. I started seeing Mr. Brian often. She would get her little treat of whipped cream.
We recognize each other, Georgette and I do. That particular day, Elaine pulls up. She said, Georgette is cancer-free.
I came around the corner with Georgette in my car, saw all the employees out there just like clapping and cheering. I started getting really emotional because I was just like, that's so nice.
We love all our customers that come through. This one just happens to have four legs. Congratulations, Georgette.
Our tradition for my football team is we dress up, shirt and tie. I had a tie, but I didn't know how to tie it. Usually I would have my dad help me, but he was deployed. I'm thinking, don't worry about it. My grandma should know.
He says, can you tie a tie? And I'm like, no, but we're on our way to Chick-fil-A.
I recognize them because they came into our store so much. Miss Bertha and Mr. Terrence, I'm like, of course, I'll help them out and show them how to tie a tie.
It wasn't just the tie, it's what was in your heart.
It's my pleasure. Mm-hmm. Doing good, man. You got it.
A lot of the media timeout here. Our final media timeout of the period. We'll get a look at that replay on that save by Nolan Egbert. This is outstanding. Said he's way out of the goal, and then Trevor Lord ends up with it. And we didn't get to it. But Egbert was way out of the goal, and Trevor Lord looking at a wide open net, threw it at the goal, and somehow Egbert able to dive back, throw a stick out in front of it, and knock the puck down. This one's going to rattle all the way around the back. Tyson Kirkby turns with it in the corner, had it poked away, and then lifted out. Mercurio tried to clear it, stays in the zone though. Thornton was able to knock it down. Got it back to Kirkby one more time. He'll control in the corner, left it there, and now skating out in front, coming out late. Yatesy lets a shot go, and they're going to score, and they're going to say no. Wow. A couple of players tangled up. Obviously, I need another look at that one. It got behind Spencer Kozlowski. Obviously, it never crossed the goal line. It stayed out. It looked like it was stuffed in behind him, but the official standing right there was immediately waving it off, so Wolves dodge a bullet there. Kozlowski's been outstanding here tonight. That one, I thought, had slipped it in. We're under a minute to play here in the period. But the official standing right there had a great view of it. Trevor Lord overskated one there a second ago, tried to get it back. It got lifted by him, came back to Tate Leeson, and he's just going to play that one all to the corner. Wolves going for a change. So Anderson back to pick it up for the Black Bears. 35 seconds left to go here, period number two. We are knotted up at two goals apiece. Pinching in was Ivan Sergeyev. Couldn't keep it in the zone. It skipped back to the outside. Kamzatov's going to send it right back in. He'll chase for Watertown, turning in the corner, left it there for Vladislav Pavlov. Pavlov got tripped up, but Kamzatov able to play it along the far side, but then it's carried out of the zone down the ice by Austin Thompson, broken up at center, and then the Clark had it for a second. Fletcher picks it up for the Bears, skates in, had it poked off his stick right at the blue line, and then Brody Thornton able to lift that one right back in, and the horn is going to sound, and that's going to take us to the end of period number two. We'll take a quick look at that from Steve Weed before we go to break here. You'll see the puck come in, and a couple of the Bears standing right there.
Wow.
And I'm not sure who the Bear player was trying to stuff that one in the back of the goal. I think actually might have cleared it out of the blue ice himself.
Yeah, I thought that might have been tossed out. And I think you're exactly right, Jeff. It came across the blue paint. And Tosto, I think, right here, 91 in the left part of your screen, trying to hammer it home, yeah, actually.
Actually stuffed it all the way across the front.
Kept it from going in. I think it would have gone in anyway, and then kept it out. So what a break that is.
That's a Watertown dodges up. Huge bullet right there.
That was behind Kozlowski.
So after 40 minutes of play, they're knotted up at two goals apiece here as we head to the break, and a lengthy conversation over on the far side of the ice. All the officials out there with the entire Black Bears team still on their bench as they finally start to trickle back towards their locker room. But there is a long conversation with Brant Sherwood on the far side. And now the Black Bears begin to head back towards their respective dressing room. So we'll take a short break after 40 minutes of play. Steve Weed, Steve Weed Productions, over here in the booth along with Connor Lalone, my partner up on the deck. My name is Jeff Barrett. Don't go away. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes.
There's cheese on a burger, and then there's cheese on a cheeseburger. Too much? Nah, don't miss the Red Robin Cheese Lovers lineup.
Red Robin.
Yum.
My Northern experience started with my mom, and I'm passing that on to my daughters.
I opened my first credit union account when statements were chiseled in stone.
Having a debit card is great because my mom can just deposit money through her account into my account.
Having the money to get food when we go on sports trips or paying our parents or grandparents back when they buy us something.
I love having all three generations of my family with Northern Credit Union.
I trust Northern Credit Union because I know that they're going to take care of us as if we are family.
Advanced Documents from ABS offers several exclusive and advanced features to support you in creating the workflow you need with minimum time and effort. Capture scanned documents as well as documents generated by other applications. Process the documents using barcode readings, converts text to digital and searchable documents, and stores the document where you determine it go. Contact our specialists at ABS for a no-cost assessment today to learn how Advanced Documents can take your business to the next level and streamline your processes.
Steak so legendary? Some say it's our flavor-packed signature seasonings. Some say it's how we pair them with our juicy, tender steaks. And some just say, Hurry in tonight for Longhorn's legendary flavors. Our new limited-time blackened salmon with our smoky 18-ounce outlaw ribeye and our rich and savory flo's filet. That's how steak is done. Longhorn Steakhouse. You can't fake steak.
We went to another
financial institution for a mortgage rate. And when we brought that to Northern, they said they would either match it or beat it. And they matched it at first, and then they even went lower and they beat it. So we decided to go with Northern for our mortgage.
Before we bought this house, we were living separate. So he would drive 2 hours to come see me in Vermont. I would drive 2 hours to come see him in New York. And this gave us a spot in the middle. So we actually get to see each other every day now.
From your head to your shoulders and your knees to your toes, North Country Orthopedic Group has you covered. The most trusted name in orthopedics is now seeing patients at Claxton Hepburn and performing surgeries at Claxton Hepburn Medical Center and Carthage Area Hospital. The highest quality of medical care you've come to expect, now closer to home. North Country Orthopedic Group, covering you from head to toe.
Got a burger here.
At Red Robin, you get all the fulls.
Red Robin.
Yum.
Where bottomless steak fries are free with every burger.
Some things never go out of style, but doing all your banking in person? Not even. Let's get digital with Northern Credit Union. It's like totally rad.
Let's get digital.
Apply for a new car loan in online and mobile banking and get that sweet new DeLorean with a gnarly sound system.
Wanna get digital.
Or get digital with Northern Credit Union by applying for a mortgage right from your phone.
Let's get digital.
Don't get stuck in the past. Get digital with Northern Credit Union.
A house isn't just a place. It's a trove of memories. It's not just a structure held together by nails and screws. It's a sanctuary for family and friends. A place to celebrate, commemorate, and nurture. At Northern Credit Union, we believe that a house is a home, and your new home is just waiting for you to fill it with memories. Apply for a loan today with Northern Credit Union, because your why is our why.
My name is Casey Hughes, and I am a nurse with Samaritan Home Health. I was fortunate enough to have great mentors during nursing school and throughout the start of my nursing career. There are so many different ways to serve your community, whether it's in a hospital setting, home care, an office. I think that new nurses should choose Samaritan because of all of the opportunities that we are given. Take care of our community and your future.
Hey, welcome to Five Star. Let me show you around. Our mission here at Five Star is to ensure our customers get the best results. The first step in this process is asking the right question. This process allows us to make the right recommendations for the products that are going to work for you and not recommend products that will not work for you. Now, let's talk a little bit about the products. When it comes to ensuring better results for our customers, our products matter. That's why we source a wide variety of vendors to ensure bringing in the most cutting-edge products that deliver results for our customers. Now, the final piece of the puzzle is accountability. When shopping at Five Star, you're given the opportunity to get free in-body readings every time you come in. This allows us to track how much muscle you're gaining, how much body fat you're losing, and paints a full picture of all the results you're accomplishing. We're so confident in our ability to make the right product recommendations that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee, no questions asked.
In the spirit of judgment freedom, Planet Fitness went to Olympia, Washington to honor all what people from that city get called. You know the way people from Boston get called Bostonians? People from Olympia, Washington get called, you know what I'm talking about. We wanted to sponsor those. Everyday those, regular those, all kinds of those. Anyways, our lawyers told us we had to make it extremely clear that we are not endorsing or sponsoring any international sporting event or affiliated athletes. We just believe that to be celebrated, you don't have to be an elite physical specimen who trains their entire life and competes in their chosen sport at the highest level all through their childhood and adolescence, and then represents their country on a world stage to compete for one of three different colored accolades. We believe that to be celebrated, you just need to join Planet Fitness.
Delaney Kuttner here with Mike from Kraft 836 Canteen.
NNY Eats, featuring Kraft 836 Canteen.
Mike, tell us a little bit about the name and the meaning behind it.
Sure, Delaney. Kraft to us means to make or produce by hand with care, skill, and creativity.
So let's head into the kitchen and check it out. We're here in the kitchen with Cody, who's gonna tell us how to make one of this place's best-selling dishes. So what are we making, Cody?
Make a sand flats cavatappi today.
And that's what I call slow food faster. All right, so Michael, tell us a little bit about what's going on over here.
So we fresh squeeze our juices here at Kraft. We wanna use fresh, because fresh is what? Fresh is best.
Mike, I was gone for 2 minutes. How did all this get here?
Well, while you were gone, I just scanned the menu and ordered everything from my phone, and the staff has been serving to our table as we've been sitting here.
For slow food faster, check out Kraft 836 Canteen. And check out more NNY Eats on informnny.com. Let's dig in. Delaney Kuttner here with Kyra Fetla at Carthage Area Hospital, and this is Health Beats. So Kyra, you work in the physical therapy department here, and you guys offer a wide range of services, including preventive care.
Physical therapy is not only restorative, but it can be proactive to prevent injuries from happening or to reduce the burden that you are already experiencing.
But that being said, you guys do help restore people who are already experiencing issues.
We treat a wide range of conditions, including after surgery, across the lifespan for babies all the way up to geriatrics. Anything that is impacting your ability to move and live in a functional way, we can help assess.
So where can people go so they can get treated by your services and come and visit your department?
The easiest way is to go to your primary care physician and ask for a referral to physical therapy. But as a physical therapist in the state of New York, I can treat people direct access, which means I can see you for 10 visits or 30 days, whichever comes first, before we need your primary care to sign off on it.
So you can find more information on carthagehospital.com and more Health Beats on informnny.com.
Hi, I'm Tony Mangano.
Hi, I'm Carmen Emmy.
We're the partners at the Hampton Inn Watertown. We have a long family history in being in business. Started with our grandfather in the early 1950s. He started a small farm in central New York. He sold produce to grocery stores. We had a little roadside farm market that we sold from. Eventually, the family business expanded into the hotel business. It came time for us to start our own projects, and Watertown was the first place we looked.
With the help of Watertown Savings, we have 3 Hiltons in Syracuse and 1 here now in Watertown. Built this hotel and then bought the one across the street a year later.
We have 90 guest rooms here, an indoor swimming pool, fitness room, and a meeting room.
We contacted Mark Bellinger at Watertown Savings Bank, and immediately after our conversation with Mark, we knew that we wanted to work with him. He listens to our plan, he asks great questions.
And he's mostly our direct line, but honestly, we do deal with other people in the organization. Terry Millott, Mark LaVarnway, and every one of them, it's the same thing. Fantastic service always.
They make you feel like you're their only customer. You don't find that with the larger institutions. We've been down that road before, and it's not there.
It's the gospel truth. It's easy to glow about them because just so down to earth and personable and very approachable always. And like Carmen said, you really feel like you're their only customer when you're talking to them.
Chick-fil-A.
I go to that Chick-fil-A all the time.
He came in the drive-thru. Before I can give him his change, he drove away. It was a month before he came back in.
Marcus hands me this envelope, and it's like $3.
I kept it in my back pocket for over a month.
It's crazy. I'm just like pretty stunned.
He's like, dude, you're serious? What?
Appreciate the $3, man. Yeah. And we found out we both play trumpet.
Extra Life is a game-oriented fundraiser for Children's Miracle Network. Either this is our 12th year, or last year was our 12th year. I think this year is our 12th year. So, I mean, it's been, we've had as many as 100 people and as little as 2 people. So it really depends on. It's free to join. You don't have to make a commitment. We don't do any online streaming. It's all like in person. We will ask for donations and stuff on our Facebook pages and our Instagram, and that'll generate a little bit, but a lot of what we do is like just in-house. We try to make it as easy for people as we can. We don't, you know, if you want to join our team and you want to try to solicit some stuff outside of it and help us out, that's great. If you don't want to even make that commitment, pop by, drop us a $20 bill, and, you know, be on your way. So, I mean, we have people pop in and they play a game for 10 minutes and they donate whatever they're going to donate, and then it's just turned into like, we try to make it a community event. This year it will be on November 4th, which is the official game day of Extra Life.
Hi, I'm Scott Skinner.
Hi, I'm Ryan Skinner.
We own the Mustard Seed. We started in 1997 wanting to own our own small business. We got involved in the organic and natural food business, not knowing the lifestyle, what the foods were, and what a resource that this business offered to our community.
We found that there was a much bigger market for organic and natural foods in the Watertown area. The more that we provided as far as offerings in the store, the more business we received. The future of the Mustard Seed would look like expanding beyond Watertown, being able to reach customers all throughout the United States.
We have been with Watertown Savings Bank for 2 decades. The service, the ability for us to reach out at any time and talk to any member of the staff has created a very friendly environment for us to work back and forth with.
Individuals like Patty Kendall, Jeff Fallon, Shelby Morja, it's really developed into much more than just a commercial relationship and feeling very comfortable working with Watertown Savings. Any endeavor that we look for going into the future, it is very comforting to know that Watertown Savings Bank is going to stand behind us and give us their support.
Welcome back inside the Watertown Municipal Arena. After 40 minutes of play, we're knotted up at 2 goals apiece. My name is Jeff Barrett, taking you through your game here tonight. Standing to my left is Connor Lalone on the color commentary and the camera. Knotted up at 2 goals apiece, as I said, after the first 40 minutes of play, and we may have a problem with audio here. Hey, fans, if you've had too much to drink tonight, make the right decision. First, think about the dangers, then think about the consequences. Stop and think before you drink. Plan for a safe ride. Funded by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration with a grant from the New York State Governor's Traffic Safety Committee. Nothing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the ACO Watertown.
So both teams making their way back out onto the ice.
Uh-huh.
Period number two ended up being an outstanding goaltender battle here between Nolan Egbert for the Black Bears and Spencer Kozlowski, both of them with some outstanding saves through the 20 minutes. So all four goals scored in the first 20 minutes of play here as both teams make their way back out to the ice. Hey fans, if you've had too much to drink tonight, make the right decision. First, think about the dangers, then think about the consequences. Stop and think before you drink. Plan for a safe ride, funded by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration with a grant from the New York Governor's Traffic Safety Committee. So back to center ice. We get set for the third period of action, knotted up at two goals apiece off the faceoff. Battle for the loose puck, carried into the Watertown end, settled down there by Trevor Lord. Gave it away in the defensive end, tossed it with a quick shot off the shoulder of Kozlowski. This one lifted high off the glass. Stone knocked it down, got taken to the ice by Tate Leeson. He'll send it cross ice to Gavin Yates. Yates tried to drag it through some legs, lost it on the way through. Now Mike Mercurio back the other direction, gets in behind Daniel Stone, came to the front of the goal, left it for Trevor Lord. It was broken up by Dakota Bond. Pass came right back through. Bond able to clear it out. Yates picks up ahead of steam, skates up between a couple of Watertown defenders, lost the puck on the way in. Tripping call is going to come to Watertown, or at least an interference call, as Yates got hauled down, tripped up on his way to the goal. It'll be William Goodboot coming over to sit down in the box. Penalty up on the board. It will be 2 minutes for hooking. William Goodboot, normally a quiet kind of kid, just look back, ask the official the question. I'm telling you, that's kind of a dangerous thing to do this season. Even if you're just asking about the penalty, you're going to get some extra minutes added. So guys have to be very careful. We've seen that a lot this season in every game we've watched, whether it's been the Wolves or wherever you've been watching Wolves hockey. Centering pass, or not just Wolves hockey, but FPHL hockey. Yates right back through center ice, tried to slide it to Austin Thompson. Near side pass was too far for him to reach. Kirk be able to keep it in the zone, though. Sends that down into the corner. Wolves able to clear this one down the ice. Egbert out of the goal, left it there for Bond. Bond being pressured by Tate Leeson, plays it off to Gavin Yates behind him. Yates picks up ahead of steam, jumps inside the offensive rush, all the way down, lost the puck on the way behind, and he's going to go down along the boards here. And Yates may have taken a high stick on this one.
Yeah, that's definitely what it looked like. Checking now for blood, but looks like it's going to be Leeson. Just the 2 minutes for high sticking. He's pleading his case. I don't know what the conversation is. Now it's...
Yep, Ivan Sergeyev would be the one that serves the penalty. It was actually, I think, Sergeyev that caught him as he went around the back of the goal.
So Leeson just doing his captainly duties and trying to... some assistance from the officiating. Did Watertown take a timeout?
Looks like they're going to here.
They did. Okay. Danbury did. Or yep. Binghamton.
Binghamton's going to take the timeout here.
Danbury might have too, but they're not here. So
we're going to take a very quick break here, I think, with just a 30-second timeout. Steve's over there in the next booth. He's kind of busy trying to straighten things out here, so... football out of the Black Bears timeout here. They're about to go on a 5-on-3. So Brant Sherwood very quickly getting his troops together. Setting up their offense here for the next minute, 16 seconds. Yates carries it around to the far side. Lost it for a second, gathered it back up. Got it back to Dakota Bond. He's in the slot. Gave it to Yates. Quick shot coming. That one turned aside. Now a foot race for the loose puck. Obviously, Bond's going to get there first, but Curio's going to go for a change. 56 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Wolves was able to break that one up at center ice as Jake Black was able to send it back in behind Nolan Egbert. He'll leave it there for Bond. Bond looks to skate up, came through center ice. Drop pass there to Yates. Yates picks up a head of steam, goes over to the left-hand side, gets behind a couple of defenders, give it to Tosto, missed on the near side. Yates with a rebound, skates out to the short slot area to Kirkby. That one denied by Kozlowski. 30 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Kirkby drop pass for Bond, lets a shot go. That's off the shoulder of Kozlowski and clear to the far side. Wolves able to poke this one off, and now a shorthanded effort on a 5-on-3. Black pick the other direction, actually gets a shot off, and Nolan Egbert sat down on that one. That almost slid five hole, and Egbert able to find it, actually reaching back behind himself with his stick to make sure it didn't squirt through his legs. So the Wolves, some great effort there to help kill time off the 5-on-3. So offensive zone faceoff with 12 seconds left in the 5-on-3. William Goodboot up to his feet. Being a defender, I imagine he's going to jump right out, stay on the ice. Anderson controls out behind. Penalty is over. Sergeyev, 40 seconds left in the 5-on-4 now. That one stays all the way into the Watertown end. Rattled around to the far side. Knockdown stayed in. Cameron Clark controls, slides it in deep. Came right back to Clark. He'll wheel back towards the far point. Now he comes through the slot area. He'll switch spots with Daniel Stone. Now he'll slide it all the way cross ice off Jesse's. Anderson skate in behind. A couple players got tangled up. Black Bears not able to get a shot off. Clark near side lets a shot go. Hit Mike Mercurio on the leg. Mercurio's going to send that one the distance. 5 seconds left in the 5-on-4. Thompson controls to the near side. And Sergeyev back out onto the ice. Jesse Anderson far side lets a shot go. That's gloved by Kozlowski. And he'll hold on for the stop in place of Watertown. Killing off a minute 18, a 5-on-3. Some great work on the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill for Watertown to first shut down the 5-on-3, then the 5-on-4. Off the faceoff, Anderson controls, lifts it all the way around the back of the boards to Tosto, has that skip by to the near side. Sergeyev had it for a second, gave it back to William Goodboot, who rattles around the backside. Wolves to the attack one more time. Gazetov with a shot. Came all the way across the front. Gingrich able to keep it in. Lifts that one towards the goal. And that bounces in on Nolan Egbert. And he has to play catcher on that one or shortstop and scoop that one off the ground. And he'll hold on to it. 3 minutes, 59 seconds gone. Period number three. Knotted up at two goals apiece here. Both goals for either team coming in period number one. Mike Mercurio, Tyson Kirkby to the faceoff circle. The scrum continues with the puck underneath them. Tate Leeson able to come away with it. Skates out to the far side. Sends it out to Black. He'll just rifle that one around the back. Picked up by Trevor Lord. Scooped that one back behind him. Mike Mercurio goes to pick it up, plays it to the near side to Grasby. Grasby's just going to send that one on goal. Leeson got the rebound, tried to slide it back out in front. And then turning with it, Yates tried to clear, had it broken up. Wolves send one right back on again. Egbert plays that off a stick, and it's up and out of play. Faceoff's going to go to the right-hand circle to Nolan Egbert's left-hand side.
Full change for Watertown. Five fresh guys out there.
Faceoff came right back out in front, not able to get to it and put a shot on. Was Black as that one came out, and then Wolves had to get back on side. Tomasi looked at it for a second and thought at the last second, wait a minute, don't touch that. But the Wolves able to get it right back into the attack zone. They'll get it in behind the goal, but it's broken up there. Anderson turning with it, lifts it around to the near side. Fitzgerald had it taken away, but it goes back to Jesse Anderson. He'll carry it out to the near side. Fitzgerald has it, stops, give it to Kyle Steven with a shot that missed all the way across the front of the goal. Connor Smith knocks it down, sends it back behind. Centering pass came right to Anderson. He'll turn, lets a shot go. That one sticked aside by Kozlowski and then cleared out. Carter Thornton was going to chase after that, but he went for a change instead. So Smith right back the other direction. Gave it to Kyle Steven, missed his shot. Wolves look to race back out of the zone, but it's turned over at center ice and lifted back into the Watertown end. Kozlowski out of the goal, settled the puck down there. Wolves looking up ice. Ivan Sergeyev able to tip that one into the offensive end. So Watertown giving a chase from there. Gamzatov had it for a second, but it's taken away by Daniel Stone. Stone lifts it out on the near side, and racing back to pick it up will be Declan Flanagan for Watertown. Flanagan chased out from behind the goal, plays it hard off the boards behind Sergeyev. So Stone controls for the Black Bears. Back into his own end, slipped it forward to Thompson. Thompson plays it hard off the glass. Sergeyev fell down, Grasby got tripped up going into the zone, but the Watertown Wolves able to come away with it. Sergeyev near side, plays it across to Pavlov. Pavlov tipped it forward to Gamzatov. It's intercepted there. Stone tried to clear. Thompson ends up with it for the Black Bears here on the near half board, I should say, if I spit some of this out in English. Right back the other direction. Bond plays it out of the zone. Kirkby tried to wheel around, but it was broken up near side by Lincoln Gingrich. Gingrich doing a great job of breaking off the offensive rush, but then the Black Bears get it there. Tosto skates in, comes right to the front of the goal, lost it on the way through. Mercurio back the other way, got it to Tate Leeson. He's got Lord on the wing. Mercurio comes down, lets the shot go. That was Leeson, let the shot go. Tried to put it back out in front. Goes and gets his own rebound, skates all the way through the slot, comes to the left circle, put it in front, down on the ice, Mercurio with a rebound. Nolan Egbert will deny both those shots. Battle for the loose puck, skating away with it, came right back out in front. Leeson turned, slid it towards the goal. Egbert flat down on his back, Mercurio couldn't put a stick on it. And Egbert finally able to recover, and he'll dive out on the puck and get himself a break that he much needed. He was way out of position, ends up prone on his backside. That'll take us to our first media timeout.
My name is Ron Thompson. I'm the owner of Uncle Sam Boat Tours in Alexandria Bay. Also Cap Thompson's Resort, Riley's by the River, Capson and Suites, and American Narrows Trading Company. Having been born and brought up on the river, you come to appreciate what we have here in our own backyard. Once we can get people here to experience it, they're always going to want to come back. So my grandfather was born in 1876. He was known as Cap Thompson. His real name was Clarence. As a teenager, started in renting out skiffs. The company's been in the family since that time, and that has evolved into six tour boats that are the largest operation on the U.S. side of the river. I've been a customer of Watertown Savings Bank since 2008. It's been a great experience. Watertown Savings Bank truly believes in the local economy. They talk about keeping business local, and they truly do that. And it's very much appreciated by businesses such as mine that have been grown here and hopefully will be here for a long time to come. There's really no need to look any further than Watertown Savings Bank. They're such a believer in the local economy. When you have a bank that keeps that money locally, that's a huge plus. It's just part of the DNA of Watertown Savings Bank. It comes easy for them.
Well, out of the media timeout, Wolves right off the faceoff get a quick shot on goal, and then this one's lifted out to center ice, knocked down by Trevor Grasby. He'll just rifle that one back in on Nolan Egbert, who has to jump up and he'll drop it to the side of his goal. Left it there for Colin Fitzgerald, slides it out the far side. Got it to Kyle Steven, quick shot. Kozlowski made the save, lost sight of it. It skipped off behind him. Smith had it far side. Centering pass came right back across. Battle for the loose puck along the boards here. Gets sent back behind Nico Hemming, had it for a second. Now Jake Black back to pick it up for Watertown. Grasby's going to end up with it. Puck came right out to the side of the goal, and then Somerville gathered it up. Got it to Anderson, back to Somerville, back to Anderson, who lifts one on goal. That's played off the skate of Nico Hemming. Or my apologies, Trevor Grasby. And then coming right back in front of big save. Grasby's dropped down in front of the shot and took it away. Pressure continues by the Black Bears. This one lifted in and gloved by Spencer Kozlowski, and we get a stop in the action. Well, folks, if you're in the Watertown area and you want to hang out with your Watertown Wolves players, join me every Tuesday night at Tully's, 1050 Arsenal Street in Watertown, for Brews with Barrett. Sit down with me and some of the players as we talk a little bit of hockey. We talk about their careers, what they do in the offseason, how they got to the pros. And we have some good dinner and a couple of drinks. It's a great opportunity to come down, have a nice meal, and hang out with your Watertown Wolves. That's Tuesday nights, 6 o'clock, Tully's, 1050 Arsenal Street in Watertown. Off the faceoff, back the other direction, falling down on the play was Garrick Lindberg. So break back the other direction. Utero with a quick shot. That'll get gloved by Kozlowski, and he'll squeeze it in, hold on once again.
Yeah, Fletcher actually lost his bucket on the faceoff. Had to come off the ice and goes back out to collect it.
Folks, if you're looking for old Watertown Wolves hockey games or old Watertown red and black football games, or maybe you're a racing fan, dirt track or asphalt, of course, we have a lot of racing here in northern and central New York. Go to Steve Weed Productions, and you can find all the old videos there that you want. A new show coming out this season. Anything old? Steve Weed and I are both old, so he just said anything old, but Steve and I are going to try to put together a little show this year that will highlight some of the racing history here in northern and central New York. So we'll get the information for that just as soon as we possibly can. Steve and I have both been around local racing way too long, right, Steve? So puck control sent out of the zone. Foot race all the way down. It's going to be Tate Leeson getting there first, though. Leeson tried to carry it around, had it poked off the end of his stick, and now carried out on the near side. Leeson going for a change. Tyson Kirkby's just going to slide it forward to Tosto. He'll skip by Trevor Grasby. Kirkby knocks it down on this near side. Stone able to keep it in the zone. Grasby got tangled up again with Kirkby. Yates races in, picks the puck up. Goes out to the faceoff circle, left-hand side. Slides it back to Daniel Stone for a quick shot. He'll slide it in. And Kozlowski will make the save and will get a stop in action. This is going to take us to our second media timeout of period number three. We'll be right back.
On today's Business Spotlight, we're excited to share with you our featured business, 1812 Brewing Company, which is a fast-growing brewery that has had some major success distributing beer to happy clients throughout New York and even into Canada. 1812 Brewery is proud to deliver a gold medal winning amber ale, which also just happens to be on its way to compete in the World Beer Championships. And if you have a small or upstart brewery, the team at 1812 can even help you with production, glass bottle and aluminum can filling and distribution. For more information on 1812 Brewing Company, visit 1812ale.com or to order beer now to your home, go to taprm.com and enter 1812 Brewing to find this great tasting beer. You can also find this great company under their stock ticker, KEGS, on the OTC.
Out of our second media timeout, offensive zone faceoff for the Black Bears. Knotted up at 2 goals apiece here in Watertown on this Sunday night matchup. Bears control, Somero has it pinned up along the boards, far side, squirts out to Dakota Bond, lifts one on, that turned aside by Spencer Kozlowski. Stone able to send it back behind again to Somero. This one's gonna squirt out between the defenders down the ice, so Bond has to retreat for the Black Bears, picks it up, settles in behind his own goal with Gamzatov keeping an eye on him. Bond slides it out to the near side, broken up by Ivan Sergeyev. Sergeyev carried it in, tried to get it to the side of the goal. Bond broke up that effort, and the Black Bears look to clue. Somero, clear, I should say. Somero sent it over, came right back to him, broken up at the blue line. And the Watertown bench are incensed over on the other side that there was no offside call. They were absolutely unloading on the official.
Yeah, I thought it looked for sure as Binghamton carried over to blue line, and Steven was offside here on the near side, got into the zone a little early, couldn't get back in time, and fortunately didn't hurt Watertown.
Puck rattles around in behind. Garrett Lindberg settles it down for Watertown. He'll look up ice, settles the puck there with 8:40 left to go in regulation. Lindberg skates out, got it to William Goodboot. Goodboot stretch pass to Trevor Lord, too far to reach. Wolves able to keep this one in. That gets rifled all the way across. Jesse Anderson going to play it off the boards to Tosto to the near side. Tosto goes cross ice. Kirkby has it, steps inside the blue line. Kozlowski out of the goal, left it there. And that one lifted high into the air in a foot race. Icing's gonna be waved off as Tate Leeson again did a great job getting into the offensive end. Mercurio tipped it forward. Quick shot from Leeson at a hard angle. Went off the side of the goal and behind. Now back the other direction. Yates carries it up. Avoids the check here at the blue line. Slides one in, lets a shot go. Got his own rebound. Slid that into Kozlowski, who covers it up, and we get a stop in play. 7:50 left to go here in regulation. So the goaltenders were outstanding through that second period of play, and they both picked it up here again in the third period. Both teams getting quality chances. But Kozlowski for Watertown and Egbert for the Black Bears equally up to the challenge. Jake Black looks to carry it in for Watertown. Goes down the left-hand side, stops in the corner, lost it for a second, gathered it right back up, plays it back to Grasby. Grasby's just going to lift one, played hard off the glass, came right out to the side of the goal. Nolan Egbert trying to find it, and he will, and covered up, and we get another stop and play. So the faceoff is going to go to the right-hand side. Josh Fletcher into the circle for the Black Bears against Jake Black for Watertown. Puck one back to the corner. Rattles all the way around to the near side. Thompson has it, lets a shot go. That's off a stick and way up out of play. And we'll get a stop in action with 7:17 left to go. Offensive zone faceoff coming for the Binghamton Black Bears. Again, Watertown will head out on the road next weekend, as well as the Binghamton Black Bears. Watertown will go to Danbury, Connecticut on Friday night. Then they'll come back and face the Elmira River Sharks in the First Arena in Elmira on Saturday night. The Binghamton Black Bears will head out to the Midwest. They'll go to Port Huron, Michigan on Friday night, and then they will face the Motor City Rockers on Saturday evening. Shout out to my friend Neil Edgar, all the way down there in sunny Florida. Former Watertown resident that relocated south, icing called here. And we'll be heading back up north next week. He will stop in Elmira on Saturday night for the contest and before making his way to Watertown to watch the following weekend. So, hey, Neil, good to hear from you. Neil's one of my biker buddies from way back and a former race car driver at Can-Am Speedway. Offensive zone faceoff for Watertown. 6:41 left in regulation. Mike Mercurio into the circle for Watertown against Austin Thompson. This one went back to the point. Gets by Grasby. Kyle Steven races down the near side. Tried to toe drag it. Lost it on the way through. Grasby ends up with it. Rattles it around the dashes to the far side. Came right through the skates of Tate Leeson. I don't think Leeson ever knew where it was. And Mercurio's got it. Tried to slide it in front. Lord couldn't get there. He was tangled up. Lifted out onto the far side. And not out of the zone. Wolves did a great job of keeping it in. Trevor Lord turning with it. Gave it to Mike Mercurio in the corner. Mercurio digs out. Races back. Puts it behind. Thornton's going to break that up, though. He'll play it back around the back of the goal to Connor Smith. Smith lifts that one out towards center ice. It's broken up by Tate Leeson. Leeson couldn't get it back to the offensive zone, though. It's controlled by the Black Bears. Colin Fitzgerald races out on the far side. Got taken off the puck on the way through. Penalty coming to the Watertown Wolves. And it's going to be Lincoln Gingrich who's going to go. He collided with Justin Somero into the offensive end, and they're going to call him for interference. 5:45 left to go in regulation, and the Black Bears about to go on the power play once again. I think Brian Verbeek is going to take his time out here.
Sure looks like it.
Yep, so Verbeek's going to take a timeout as the Wolves get ready to go on the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill. Lincoln Gingrich, 2 minutes for interference. Like I said, a collision on the way into the offensive zone. And they call him for the interference on the play.
Yeah, I'm not sure there was really a ton in it. I mean, Gingrich and Somero kind of just tied up one of those plays where two guys are battling for position, battling for chance to play the puck, and Somero ended up on the ice, and Gingrich ends up in the penalty box. So.
Yeah, it looked like at the last second, maybe Gingrich got an arm up into the chest area, but the odd thing about that was Somero goes down to his back, and it took the official about 3 seconds before putting his hand up in the air, so he kind of thought about it over on the far side, but probably processing what he did see. I would hate to be an official. I used to do it for lacrosse, and you can think you called the greatest game of your life, and you're going to hear it when you get off the field by everybody else. So if your team wins, they did a great job. If you lose, you were horrible. Gavin Yates carries it to the far side, wheels back to in the corner, lost it for a second. He'll gather it back up, got it back to Bond. Bond comes to the slot area, slides it over to Kirkby. Kirkby goes all the way cross ice to Yates. Yates drops back to Bond again in the slot. He'll fake the shot. Now he'll lift one on goal. That one denied by Kozlowski, goes to the corner. Thornton goes over to dig it through there along with Blake Tasso. They continue to dig for the loose puck. This one came back out to the slot. Kirkby had to play it off a skate, couldn't get a shot off, and the Wolves able to send that one the distance. Tate Leeson chasing in on that one, trying to take a little bit of time off this. Kirkby slides it forward to Gavin Yates. Yates drop pass for Thompson near side. Thompson rifles one. That goes off the blocker of Kozlowski, And the Wolves looking to clear far side. Jake Black picks up the puck, slides it to their side. They score! Carter Thorian, a shorthanded goal, and Watertown takes a 3-2 lead. Wow, give Jake Black credit. That was an absolutely beautiful pass that left Carter Thornton on the left-hand side with a wide-open net and just slapped it to the top of the cage. And Watertown gets the shorty with 4:46 left to go in regulation.
This is just an absolutely crucial penalty kill for Watertown, not only in the game but on their season. And to do something like that, end up with a 2-on-1, and like you said, perfectly executed pass by Jake Black. Able to find Thornton, and he hammers it home one time right into the back of the net to give Watertown the lead.
We'll get another look at it here from Steve Weed. You'll see Egbert comes out playing the angle way out of the goal, but then that pass came over, and he had no chance to get the pad back to the other side.
Perfect feed. Conversation going on here. Not really sure what that's about. Leeson heading back to the locker room like he's done for the night, so that's got to be something that was said. Like you said, Jeff, the referees have been very sensitive all year. Anything is said, anything perceived to be negative towards them from a player, from a coach, I mean, it's a pretty short leash. And looks like Leeson is going to see his night end a little early. That's a big loss for Watertown here with a one-goal lead. 4 minutes and 20 seconds here trying to close one out.
This one will get cleared back out through neutral ice. 30 seconds left in the Carthage Area Hospital penalty kill. You know, Connor, to your point, I think that was a point of emphasis at the beginning of the season that the league put out to the official or to the players and officials. They weren't going to put up with a lot of the nonsense that we'd seen.
And they haven't.
No, they haven't. The officials got very short with their whistles this season. Puck controlled, tapped out of the zone by Carter Thornton, who just picked up the goal. Sends that one down, 3:48 left in regulation. Gingrich up to his feet, 2 seconds, one. We are back to all even. Somero has it near side, lifted it forward to Yates. Yates steps inside the zone, drop pass, came back to Yates, winds up, lets a shot go. It was down on the ice as Kozlowski made the save. Stone ends up with a rebound, got it to Fitzgerald, far side, back to Stone in the slot, fires one on goal. That one knocked down, that's gonna get sent to distance. It'll get an icing call, but the Wolves needed to get a little bit of a break there, a lot of confusion and a lot of pressure coming from the Bears, so not an absolute horrible icing at that point. Offensive zone faceoff coming for the Black Bears. Tyson Kirkby going into the faceoff circle, far side. Now we got a couple officials coming over here to talk to the scorers booth. I don't think we ever had, I think Steve Weed just nailed that on the head. I don't think we've had a media timeout, and now we will. This will take us to our last media timeout. We'll be right back in Watertown.
At Bob Johnson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown, goal number one is to be number one. To break volume sales records, we're clearing the lots with Bob Johnson pricing. During the President's Day sales event, lease the all-wheel drive 2024 Dodge Hornet RT, the most powerful compact utility vehicle, $299 a month. Bob Johnson, Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Watertown. This is where the savings are. Bob Johnson.
back inside the Watertown Municipal Arena. You folks at home, hey, don't worry. I'm going to walk over to the next booth and slap Steve Weed when this is over. He keeps throwing that steak up there. You know, this game started shortly where dinner time should have been. So we haven't eaten yet, and he's throwing that stuff up on the screen. Puck to the near side. We can approach 3 minutes to go here. In regulation, Tyson Kirkby winds, sets a shot across the front. Bond with the rebound, far side, puts it right back in front, and Kirkby scores! Tyson Kirkby got the rebound, came to the near side, and did what he had to do. He lifted it to the top of the cage over a sprawling Spencer Kozlowski.
Yeah, here's the look. Little fortune for Kirkby as that puck hits a couple of bodies in front, works its way over. And I thought for a second maybe we were going to see some more magic from the Wizard of Kaz, but doesn't quite come up with a glove save. Kirkby able to beat him up high into the top shelf with a great one-timer. And just like that, we're all back even.
Tyson Kirkby, goal number 32 on the season. For Kirkby, that's also his 70th point on the year. Tyson Kirkby doing what Tyson Kirkby does. Sitting right there, took the opportunity of the rebound, stuffs it home, and we're knotted up again after the Wolves had jumped into the lead. Anderson far side controls, drop pass there for Thompson, lost the puck there, Mercurio took it away for a second. That one gets skipped outside, and now an opportunity. Gamzatov gonna get behind, penalty coming. Watertown's gonna get a power play out of this, and a quick shot coming, touched up. And that'll get a whistle, but I think we're going to see an interference call as Gamzatov was held up trying to get to the loose puck. So coming over to sit down will be Cameron Clark. Two minutes, 11 seconds left in regulation, and the Wolves will play 2 minutes of that with an extra skater.
Big opportunity for Watertown. Took the momentum with that shorthanded goal. Kind of packed it in a little bit. Went turtle mode, defensive, and ended up giving up the equalizer. Now, chance on the power play.
Out to Trevor Grasby, slides it in front. Quick shot coming, and Egbert's going to lay down on his back and cover that one up. It was free for a second to the near side. 2:05 left to go in regulation. Tyson Kirkby's going to skate to the faceoff circle for the Bears in against Jake Black for Watertown. Black won the faceoff. It came back to Mike Mercurio, who tried to send it across. It was pass was broken up. Now Gamzatov able to send it right back to the offensive end. Bond has it, rattles it around. Jake Black kicks it along, keeps it in the zone for Watertown. Now it's lifted out by Kyle Steven. That'll go down the length of the ice. Icing's going to be waved off. So the Black Bears going for a change. Trevor Grasby sends it cross ice to Trevor Lord. That one broken up, came back to Mike Mercurio, lifted that one forward, and it's carried in by Alexander Gamzatov, broke it up. Mercurio ends up with it, slides it in to Trevor Lord. Lord stops here to the near side on the half board. Now he'll just send one in towards the goal, and that's going to go in and be gloved by Nolan Egbert. He'll hold on to it. Minute 15 left to go in regulation. Well, you got to be wondering, I wonder if Brian Verbeek now is second-guessing his timeout earlier when he could have an opportunity to set up something here with the power play with just 2 minutes left to play. Off the faceoff, skipped out to the far side, stays in the zone. Vladislav Pavlov carrying it up, comes right to the back of the goal, puts the brakes on there, looks up top, got it to Black. Black put it back down front, they score!
They're waving it off?
Yep, the official's waving it off.
Oh, no.
Well, that clearly hit the back of the net, so I'm not sure what the call will be here.
see if Steve's got a better look at it.
Nothing there.
I have no idea.
We have a goal there. That's a good goal.
There's no goaltender interference.
Nope, the collision comes after
and
the goal
Egbert's
is scored.
And Egbert's outside of the blue paint anyway. There's no possibility of a high stick. The puck hits the net. It's clearly over the
it's
line.
It's clearly a goal. It's just...
I don't understand.
I don't understand here either.
Maybe this is the only other thing I can possibly think of is that it's maybe a high stick, but it doesn't. I mean... Yeah, I don't... I don't know.
I have no explanation on that one.
Unless there's something that we all missed watching it, I don't.
I think they're trying to say he kicked it in. Now
okay,
that's
maybe.
What they're trying. The official talking to Trevor Lord was pointing at his foot.
That's can't
obviously
tell from
not,
there.
Obviously not kicked. I mean, the shot was from outside, about by the circle. It may have hit a skate on the way through. That is absolutely no goal. And the officials.
Yeah, I mean, they're ready for a face-off in the neutral zone.
Yep.
Which I have zero understanding of how that could have possibly been disallowed. I don't see that at all.
No, I look forward
had.
To the explanation of this one.
None of the.
There's absolutely
angles.
Nothing there to take that goal off the board.
See how Watertown responds if they're fired up about it, because I think, be completely honest and try to be Jeff. Both of us try to be as unbiased as possible. I think that was. I think that was the wrong decision. I think Watertown was pretty hard done by right there.
I hate to say that, but I will say they got robbed on that one. Quick shot coming, rebound in front. They score again!
I don't think that one was kicked, Jeff.
The official emphatically pointing at the back of the goal this time. So... Well, Watertown's going to take the lead with 14.9 seconds left on the board. They will make it 4-3.
That's how to respond. I mean, that's the way to do it. You get a funky bounce off the back of the board. And Lord there to hammer home the rebound. You get a decision that doesn't go your way.
Yeah.
You come out and answer right back and put one in the back of the net anyway.
Looks like Trevor Lord is going to be sent off.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what, you just scored the goal to make it a 4-3. If you're a Wolves right now, just keep your mouth shut, skate away, don't cause any problem. And hold on for an absolutely huge win here tonight.
Again, not sure what he said. He clearly gestured and said something to the Binghamton bench when he skated through, but at the same time, I think it's pretty reasonable to expect him to be fired up right now. I think that's maybe a little harsh. Send him off. Again, not sure what was said, but.
Well, either way, Nolan Egbert has gone to the bench. So the Binghamton Black Bear is going to get the extra skater here right off the draw, and it's going to go right into the offensive end for Watertown. So that one's going to get rattled around to the near side. Grasby broke it up. Black sends that one to the zone. 4 seconds left, and the Watertown Wolves faithful are on their feet. An absolutely huge weekend as Watertown takes two from the league-leading Binghamton Black Bears, 4-3 here tonight. And Watertown has tied the Elmira River Sharks for the last playoff spot on the weekend. And the fans here are celebrating Watertown, an absolutely outstanding effort the last two nights here in the building. And even with a goal being pulled off there with less than a minute to play, got one back anyway and find their way to a victory. And the Binghamton Black Bears are gonna travel home after two losses here in Watertown. Boy, where has this been for a while? What a gutsy effort by the Watertown Wolves all weekend. They will pick up the 4-3 win here this evening.
Yeah, and they deserved it. They deserved both the wins they got this weekend. They fought hard, they played really hard. They played the full 60 minutes, something absolutely that they haven't done all year. But they did it this weekend. They did it when it really mattered. And all of a sudden, see a little life out there. It's good to see that from them.
So the Watertown Wolves head on the road next weekend. They will go to Danbury on Saturday night, Elmira on Saturday night for a very key matchup down there in First Arena. The Binghamton Black Bears head out to the Midwest, take on Port Huron. On Friday night, Saturday, they will battle the Motor City Rockers. We're back home a couple weekends after that for a three-game set here in Watertown. I want to thank you for sticking out with us all weekend long. Thank you for putting up with my coughing and hacking. I do apologize for that. Poor Steve Weed. Don't laugh at me, Steve. I'm trying to breathe over here. For Steve Weed Productions, Wolves TV, for Connor Lalone, my partner up here on the deck, hopefully I don't give him a cough like I had all week. My name is Jeff Barrett. We'll see you back in a couple of weeks. Thanks for hanging out with us.
Three-star selection.